twice gone all in life. One time into Epigam and then into Fund One of Sauce. Really? Put all my savings in. Yeah, yeah.
You put all your savings in. How did Hocco start was, the naming was not important. I just wanted something with H. My last name is Chona. So Hocco stands for House of Chona. HOC thoda incomplete lag raha tha. So uske aage CO ka dal dete. House of Chona, collaborative company, jo bhi dana.
Not a single brand at mass was less than 50 to 60 years old. Amul, Mother Dairy, Wadilal, 60-70 saal purane brand.
It is an impulse product. Today, if you're on the highway, you're driving from, say, Delhi to Agra, you'll stop, you'll not say, agar ye brand hai, toh hi main rukunga. Whatever is there, as long as it's a brand you recognize or you think that is, you know, something that you would be happy, that you'd be okay consuming, you'll have it. Since COVID, the whole industry has grown, and you ask people why, nobody knows the answer also. People have just started consuming more ice creams.
We found success in whole tooth, we found success in pet care with Super Tails. But baki hamare jo winners nikal rahe hain is Hocco ice creams, Mokobara luggage. Bahut hi bade established categories jahan pe incumbents itne bade hain ki unko innovation ka there is no motivation. Yeah. But the consumer's awareness, disposable income now want something new and you're not going to do it. You'll never do it as a strategy, you'll never do it. Why would I? So these guys will come, they will take share, they will grow up.
I know we've been trying to do this for a while and I've been generally sort of thinking, yeah, what can I say here that will add value to anyone's life? Aisa kuch ukhada nahi hai. But at least when we spoke last, I thought, chalo, you know, Ankit's story is something which can be super interesting and how we got about working together and so on. Is at least something maybe resonates with a few new founders or thinking about starting out and so on. So Ankit and I actually we met over whiskey.
Yeah, we met at a whiskey tasting, this Drammers Club thing.
Huh.
So the first time I was...
My first investment before Sauce and so on was this yogurt brand called Epigamia.
Yeah, of course.
So Rohan was the founder. Yeah. So he, if he loves anything more than yogurt, it's whiskey. Okay. Like he's absolutely batshit crazy about good whiskey, right? Yeah. So he started this really cool India chapter of a whiskey club called Drammers.
Okay.
Which is run by this guy called Charlie. Who New York se aata hai, he travels to every country, 22 countries mein wo travel karta rehta with whiskey in his check-in bag, right? So it's a really cool thing, very non-pretentious. We just have pizza and kebab, but it's all about the whiskey. So wahan pe I met Ankit over again and then started chatting.
How long back was this?
This was, I think, 2018.
Okay.
So I just sold my business and I was figuring out what to do in life. And as I said, this is the first time I'd been to this Drammers Club thing. And I was that time living in Ahmedabad, where I'm from. So, you know, I met him and then he gave me his card and saying, I said, Sauce.vc. I said, what do you do? And this and that. And I'd just taken up an office space in WeWork in Bombay. And I show up to office a couple of days later there and I see him
again.
I said, hey, we met again, you know. And then I started chatting with him about what he's doing and all. And even he knew that, you know, I just sold my business and all of that. So similar space. And we had, as Rohan was a common friend, I said, you know what, this sounds really exciting. I'd love to invest in your fund.
Okay.
So you, I think, one of the first few investors in his fund.
In fact, Sauce One was a really small fund. It's a 60 crore fund.
Okay.
Usme main apna pura jama punji dal liya 10 crore. And this guy and Rohan are the two other backers with reasonable checks. Because us time pe kuch tha nahi na, who's Sauce, who's Manu, never done early stage kuch nahi. So it was basically people who took a leap of faith over me. And so just... So that's how it really started. So 2019, when we launched Fund One, he was one of the first big backers. And so it's come a full circle now that he backed me when I started and now I'm backed him when he started.
So how did that fund do? How did that fund
very
do?
Phenomenal, phenomenal. Touch wood. I mean, I think it's, we're now in year four and we took money years 1, 2, 3. Year four, man, we pura return kar diya. So in a 2-year old, we've returned.
It's been one of the best performing investments from our family office. Was his
I mean, look at the more than the performance, and just look at the brands we got to back. So all of these are idea stage investments, pre-revenue.
Which idea stage? Is like 15 crore ka
pre-rev. Pre-rev. Sirf idea hai, product bhi nahi hai.
So kya valuation hota hai? 15 crore. Like my.
Jo baithe saath mein coffee piya, jo kar liya kar liya. There's no science to it. There's no, what I always try and avoid is to overdilute a founder, right? Because in a consumer business, the outcome is not going to be like a multi-unicorn.
Correct.
And you will need capital till a series B or C.
Correct.
So, paisa lagega, dilution hoga. That's the reality. That you cannot reverse.
Okay.
So, let's not try and overdilute. So, I used to take a minimal stake and be there to back them when they needed money. And but I was also very clear, I'm not going to overcapitalize you. So, we will drip in money as you grow. And banayenge phir. So, initial checks used to be really small, 1.5-2 crore ke checks.
That's enough to get off the ground.
To get off the ground, exactly. With an idea, yeah, that's enough. And so we backed the whole Truth Foods.
Oh, wonderful.
So us time pe Shashank came with just literally a brown paper mein ek chota sa tukda leke aaya tha. And I was like, not. And that was the third guy pitching a protein bar to me that week. And there's this guy of mine who's been with me from day zero, Zoeb. And Zoeb and I were like, yaar, ek aur protein bar. I was like, but yaar, ye banda bahut sahi hai, bahut sahi hai. To ye kuch to todu banayega. So Zoeb said, chalo yaar, chak lete hain. Like, we hadn't even tasted it after he left. And we had it, like, ye to kuch to hai, to ye kuch to karega. And, you know, a lot of passion. So let's go ahead.
Also, I am Lucknow, by the way.
Yes.
I am Lucknow, by the way. I'm from Ahmedabad, Lucknow actually, hats off, has a far better entrepreneurial culture than Ahmedabad. I also think that we get really good jobs, so people become really lazy. And Lucknow is a little bit of a struggle.
Consultants come out of Ahmedabad, I think entrepreneurs come out of Lucknow.
Yeah, I agree.
Another thing with Lucknow, we'll come back to what you're talking about, but Lucknow ka ye, there is not a single person at Lucknow who would have got an Ahmedabad admit and landed up at Lucknow.
Yes.
Everyone at Lucknow has wanted to go to Ahmedabad, but come to Lucknow because the differences are minor. So, the fire in the belly, hota hai na, even in McKinsey, for example, we were only 2 hours from IIM Lucknow.
Yeah.
Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Calcutta, 10-10 bache the.
Yeah.
Right? And hum do, and unke alumni groups were big in the firm. So, getting staffed, like an Ahmedabad partner will pick up an Ahmedabad guy, who's going to interview kiya hoga, jo bhi hai, right? And Lucknow, all are like waiting. And you always, the firm, it's not structural. Or even intentional, but it just so happens. It's not. Aajkal nahi hota, but 2011 ki baat kar raha hu. Lucknow guys always used to get thoda sa. You have to work a little bit extra.
Yeah, yeah.
To kind of get the same opportunities.
But they've grabbed the entrepreneurial opportunity and how? Yeah. Like there's one of my closest friends in VC is a guy called Anshu. Also an IIM Lucknow guy.
Correct.
And uska saale ka deal flow is so phenomenal because he's. So I actually
hustle
so I actually told him, yaar, I am Lucknow ka jab event hoga na, to mere ko zarur bulana because I want to become friends here. And I've never been to an IIMA. I mean, sorry to my institute for that, but I've never been to an IIMA event because I don't think wahan se bahut bade todu phodu entrepreneurs nikalte hain. Wahan pe itna aag nahi hai. They get so pampered with corporate jobs.
And 2006, Anshu's batch is a bunch of amazing people.
Yeah.
So there is Deepak Garg from Rivigo.
Again,
crazy. I don't know if you've seen this company.
Yeah.
Deepak Garg, Rivigo. Like, up and down story, but that guy has just been just hustling
solid,
max. Yeah. Then Shiv, the founder of Indigo
Edge. Indigo Edge, yeah.
There are bankers for this.
There are LPs with us as well.
Oh, really?
And also bankers to us and our portfolio.
Wow. So they're doing our Series D.
Achha.
And Shiv is the founder.
He's solid.
But kaha se chalu kiya? And then suddenly kind of found his way into investment banking.
Yeah.
And just like serious hustle. Yeah. I'm sorry, but coming back to your portfolio.
I mean Whole he knows most. Whole Truth Kia. Then, you know, there's this luggage brand called Mokobara.
Wow.
Those guys.
He got me on the cap table a lot of these companies. So I'm very happy.
Through the fund or also separately?
No, also separately.
Yeah, I missed Sangeet, no?
Sangeet.
I missed it. And I met him at Ashish Goyal's birthday party.
Ashish
Goyal, the founder of Urban Ladder. And again, McKinsey is like a very good mentor to me.
And to them also. A very big mentor to them.
They're
alumni
of Double Ladder. And we met them. Wahan pe Sangeet was like throughout non-sober. There are deal I had for 4 pay. Like, I was not able to get in touch with you. Ashish like was not responding. So I didn't get, abhi kar lo, abhi kar lo. Chal, mere 10 lakh le le, etc. And wo hua hi nahi, yaar. Wahan Goa se nikal gaye. Aur nikal gaye. And now all I invest in is buying his bags.
Like, he'll get you a discount coupon
for the round, yaar.
Anyway, yaar, amazing story there. But what a roller coaster for them, right? Really? I mean, so humne paisa dala. So maine apna pair tod liya tha playing football. So mera ACL surgery hua tha. So main ghar pe baitha tha, humne nick karwaya. Aur ye dono aaye ladke apna ek unka first that was the first Mokobara cabin leke ghar pe aaye. I saw the bag and I was like, ki boss. ये तो वैसे ही बहुत ही jaded category है, right? There is clearly an opportunity to talk to the new age consumer, and I know कि और कुछ करें ना करें, Gen Z is like all over social and traveling. इनके दो passion है, right? तो ये तो travel करेंगे तो ये दिखाएंगे social पे कि हम किसके साथ travel कर रहे हैं, the airport look and so on, and these guys will nail this shit.
Correct.
And perfect combo, like, and इतना आगे, like coming back to your point, one boy from Kanpur, one from Raipur, जिंदगी में पैसा नहीं देखा, but want to think and dream so big. So it was literally the game. I used to be on the 8th floor. They came up to my house. We sat for like 35, 40 minutes. Then I said, okay, chalo, bye. So they went down and at my gate waiting for an Uber, they were smoking. I sent them, yeah, I'm in. So it was literally a 30-minute conversation. I was totally in. Then COVID hit. Everything went down in relation to travel, right? Okay. So that was a really tough phase for them because kya hota tha? Hamara founder WhatsApp group hai, right? Jab e-com sort of started, right? Before stores opened, everything was in e-com. So sabke numbers were going through the roof. And everyone was giving high fives and, you know, so on. ROS is 6 and ROS is 8. And hamare ladko ke bilkul chalu hi nahi ho raha tha. So I think that was a real phase of low for them. And usme you self-doubt. And then you get into ki yaar ab kya karein, yaar luggage nahi karna hai, to kitchen wear kar lete hain, kyunki design hume aata hai, let's do something that we can do and all of that. So bahut kuch kiya, but we figured that, you know, aayega kabhi na kabhi, right, wapas. So paise nahi the. So I said, let's hunker down, cut burn, and let's do whatever we can to not spend and burn money. So we started building a pipeline for bags. तो बैग्स में हमने काफ़ी काम किया, सप्लाई चेन बनाया, बहुत अच्छे बैग्स डिज़ाइन किए. आई सेड यार एयर ट्रैवल मे नॉट स्टार्ट बट ऑफिस इज विल स्टार्ट एंड सो ऑन. सो दैट स्टार्टेड एंड देन लॉट ऑफ स्टार्ट्स एंड स्टॉप्स, पैसा खत्म हो गया.
डैम फकिंग हार्ड पीरियड.
या वेरी
व्हेन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स लाइक व्हेन योर अदर कोहोर्ट एंटरप्रेन्योर्स आर लाइक रेजिंग मनी.
या
लाइक दिस इज 2021 आई एम अज्यूमिंग व्हेन लाइक देयर वाज अ बूम इन वैल्यूएशंस एंड लाइक पीपल लाइक चेक्स आर बीइंग रिटन लेफ्ट हैंड एंड सेंटर. इट्स वेरी हार्ड टू कीप योर ओन.
या
I can tell you this from personal experience.
No, it's very tough. It's extremely tough. However much you try and put on blinders, it's extremely tough. You don't know. And, you know, what did they... They raised 2 crores from us. Kitna, how far is two? You can't get it through 3 years. Then we told them... So we backed them with nothing at that point again. Like we said, chalo. And then got in some friends, got in Ankit and so on. And we just, that was like, you know, and that for me also is a dilemma, right? Because I have a fiduciary. I'm managing someone else's money. Mera paisa nahi hai. And though I may feel extremely passionate, I have to be super disciplined as well, right? So how do I, at that point in time,
support the founder
and also give them capital, because that is one of the principal supports they need, right? Correct. So of course you give them time and empathy and so on, but capital bhi chahiye. So it's really difficult.
Yeah.
And you need to keep your checks and risk management, everything spot on. But then it, like, then travel came back and how, and that's
So hold to then Mogo Bar again.
XYXX is a men's undie story. Again, like, phenomenal founder out of Surat, now a really close friend also with an insane sense of humor. So wo bhi wahi yaar, matlab sabne bola ki, and by the way, these are deals which everyone passed. Everyone in the market has passed all of these deals, I think, other than Whole Truth. So, Surat ka ladka, you know, his story was very different. He was like, ki main aapse paise kyun hoon? And my dad has money. So, you know, so I was like, yaar, ye to banayega kuch bada. So, Zoe banayi used to do the Shatabdi from Borivali to Surat.
Yogesh, right?
Ha, Yogesh is the founder.
Nah.
And we went and sort of worked with him 6 months to convince him to take our money.
Really?
Ha. Then he took our money, and then it's been a really good journey. And then there's Innovist, which is Bear Anatomy.
Yeah.
And
the man company guy, yeah.
He's been through, started with personalization, realized ki bhaiya ye to dunya bhi jayegi before Indians start personalizing.
Correct.
And the complexity of that supply chain. So then he went into hair care. Now he's doing really well. So some of those turned out to be really good. And for a 60 crore fund, to have 10-20% of these kind of companies, it's, the numbers add up really well. So very lucky with our journey.
And then Hocco happened?
And oh, then...
Hocco, how would I pronounce it?
Hocco.
Hocco, okay. Huh.
Hocco, so, Hocco was a very long conversation, by the way.
So what happened was, I think, so I met Manu in 2018. We invested in this first fund. We invested in the second fund. All the companies that he mentioned, XYXX, Hocco Bara, we also, we invested together outside the fund as well.
At the Angels, huh?
So I said, Manu is like a good luck charm. every time, and obviously, so, you know, COVID happened, and before that, my restaurant business. So I had also gone through a very tough phase. You know, I did one startup that didn't do very well initially.
Which one was
it? It's called Fab.
Okay.
In the protein space.
Okay.
but what happened? I started Fab in Feb 2020.
Is it protein? Is it protein bars or powder?
Protein bars, powders.
Okay.
Ready to drink protein shakes. It's still there. It's doing well now. But obviously, the ambitions there now have are not as big as for the ice cream business. But again, I still feel that that's a space I don't want us to leave. And now my wife heads it, and she's a nutritionist by profession, so she's kicking ass in there.
Okay. Yeah.
So I should keep coming to him. Not more. I said, would you invest in this? He's like, to ice cream kar. You know, then I'd say, would you? I'm thinking about this ready-to-eat business. He said, all that is fine. You do ice cream. I said, okay. I said, well, I have a non-compete. So he said, no, we'll wait. I said, okay. And then COVID happened, and my restaurant business went down in the dump. So, you know, when he's talking about self-doubt and, you know, laying off people, that it was the most difficult thing. And, you know, the dilemma that I had was, you know, you have personal wealth because you sold your business, and it's a public knowledge that you have. But then you have, like they said, the discipline, right? And you know you have a business that's sucking out your wealth.
Yeah.
And you have these people that you need to let go who have been with you. So I was at the lowest point during COVID and, you know, post that and all. So then I moved to Dubai because, you know, when the Delta variant happened, we just said, you know what, I got to do this for my family and all. So we moved to Dubai. And then from Dubai, I should keep doing Zoom calls with him. Main ye idea soch raha hu, main wo idea soch raha hu. He said, tu Dubai mein ek saal chill kar, tera non-compete khatam ho jayega, tu wapas aa jana, then we'll talk. I said, okay, done. And that's how, I reached out to him saying that, listen, I'm starting now. I'm going to start reaching out. And then he said, okay, you know, we're happy to invest. We discuss valuations, all of that. And
kya discuss valuation?
But explain this to me, right? I think there are two things which I want to unpack here. One is, of course, your belief that a third generation entrepreneur who's come in the money, like the family, like this is, I'll tell you very honestly, as a promoter, and I'm sure with other founders as well, I think it's a big moment to emotional, in a good and bad way, both, to create a business which is, 75 years when you started it, and to create the kind of, you know, multi-generational wealth that you're able to create and then deploy and create more business, right? It's an amazing milestone. But to identify that this person can again do 0-1 journey and you want to be a part of that.
Let me flip it around to you, Shantanu. Let's say hypothetically, तू आज बॉम्बे शेविंग को बेचता है, यू रन इनटू अ रीजनेबल सम ऑफ मनी व्हिच विल बी इंटरजेनरेशनल और व्हाटएवर यू नो वेल्थ फॉर यू. तू उस पैसे के साथ क्या करेगा ब्रो? लाइक यू विल गेट द मनी, फर्स्ट यू विल स्पेंड इट, देन यू रियलाइज यू कांट स्पेंड इट, एंड देन यू विल बी लाइक व्हाट द हेल डू आई डू विद द रेस्ट ऑफ माय डे, बिकॉज़ देयर इज सो मच टैलेंट, सो मच एंबिशन, सो मच फायर एंड सच अ लॉन्ग लाइफ.
करेक्ट.
तो यू कैन नॉट, एंड दैट विद अंकित was always the case. I think he went through his phase where he came into money and he, like,
it's a full circle that you have to live through, and I'll come to that, but you finish.
But promoters are cash rich, they're asset heavy, but cash rich, like, in general, of course.
No. See, I'll
by
tell
rich,
you.
By poor, like, by...
It's a relative scale, right? Your wealth is relative to how much you need. The other person has, or how much you need or you want, right? There's never enough. There's always somebody who you aspire to be, or there's somebody that, I think what you just, you know, what Manu also just said, that it is a whole cycle that you go through. So for me, you know, when we sold the business, my dad and me, and we all were on the same page that ice cream is a tough business. My dad and I have done it for 40 years. If we get a good deal and we get a good exit, let's do it. I said, are you sure? He said, yes. I said, even I was on the same page. So we were very, like, it's not like people actually thought, and I'll tell you the way we sold the business also, because it's a really cool story. So I said, okay, you know, I'm running this mandate and this Korean company is ready and, you know, very excited.
Who did that deal?
Lotte.
Who the banker who did the deal?
KPMG.
Yes, because they came and presented to us for our series deal. Also, that was like one of the highlights of that.
So, I mean, they just came to my office and saying a quick, no name basis. There's some Asian company with a presence in India, $100 billion. I said, so Reliance or Tata lag raha hai. So they said, no, non-Indian. I said, okay. And then their head office is in Chennai in India. So I Googled, is that whatever, I found a Lotte. I said, but that's very odd that a Korean company was in. But then it turned out to be them only. And then we gave them the mandate thinking, ki nahi hoega. You know, dekhte kya hota and all that. And then the deal happened.
But were there multiple buyers? Or like, did you do a proper sell side?
Yes, we did. But, you know, I had done that a few years ago. That time I wanted to sell the business for half the value at which we sold it eventually. And I got an offer which was 25% of the... Well, and that's how I got Accenture on board. I said, you know, I need to clean up my business. I needed to be professional. I needed to, you know, all those matrices that I thought would matter. We were like frogs in a well. And when we got these people on board and all, then suddenly we realized that we are really unlocking value. And So, you know, when you sell a business, which, you know, where I was, the thought came in my head is, it's the biggest high of your life. You know, it validates everything that you've done. To actually get money in the bank, you know, I get goosebumps when I think about that day. It was 17th December, SMS, right? Or 16th. One SMS that, and again, Japesh was the one who was doing the banking detailing for me and all that. And he sends me this, you know, work is hard when your bank balance is as big as a phone number and this and that, and you know, all of that stuff. And you're like on a high. Everybody, I got the maximum number of phone calls, this, that, everything is happening. And you're on the front page of newspapers and all of that. And you enjoy it, right? And you suddenly feel that, oh, this is insane. I've got more wealth that the interest that I'll accumulate if I just do this much and that much and all of that. You start thinking in that direction. But then, there are one of two ways you can go, right? Once, okay, this all settles down.
How long did that take?
It doesn't take very long. Depends on how you deploy the money also. Because while it can go up, it can also go down, right? So I deployed just when the markets are crashing and all of that. So it was a tough period for me. You know, I was like, but I think it lasts about a year.
Okay.
About a year, you know, till you're still, you know, till when do you, you know, and then suddenly you realize, okay, what is my purpose in life? From being in a business where you had 1,000+ employees, you know, you were taking decisions that impacted so many lives, to now being in a family office where you have 4 employees. You had the restaurant business. I'm not discounting that. But, and then you're just investment companies like you. Yeah. And I would look at you and say, this guy has so much drive. Once I've written the check to you, I can't keep calling you every 3 days. Kya kar raha hai, right? I can't. By the way, the companies I've invested in, XYXX, never met the promoter. Only Zoom call. Mokobara, never met Sangeet. Only Zoom call. Yeah, never, not even done a Zoom call with him. In fact, I just know he exists. He knows I exist. Nirali is the one who's done all the talking and all that. So, I mean, then what do? You know, and started a startup, this, that and all, but you didn't reach anywhere in scale. And you're used to, like, you know, hiring certain people at that, you know, skill set and all. And suddenly, because you don't have the wealth, you can't hire all those people and all that. And then that is when the frustration sets in. And that is where you feel that you need to do something more in life.
The itch is there.
It's not about money. It's just about purpose. It's about being relevant. It's about, you know, being like 6 years ago, you asked me, what do you do for a living and where do you live? I'd say, well, I run Havmor and I live in Ahmedabad.
Yeah.
3 years ago, if you asked me, what do? I said, you know, well, there are these so many brands. I run a family office. I live in Dubai, Bombay, Ahmedabad. I would give my answer based on how much time you have. You know, so it became like, so you are actually lost in this whole thing.
Is it an identity? Like a lot of promoters.
Huge identity crisis.
Yeah, yeah.
They just, because their company is who they are.
Yeah.
And
like, and that's true for most of us who, I mean, find purpose in our work, right? So, iske baat karenge kya? Agar, if somebody asks me, so I've been approached to sell Sauce by large AMCs. The point is, main karunga kya, boss? Like, what do I do if not Sauce? And what, you know, I don't have an answer. He doesn't have an answer. Or didn't have an answer. And, you know, you'll probably come to, and for most founders, I see this. And the reason why I wanted Ankit also to talk today is that this is the dilemma in a lot of founders' minds who are sort of already at a mid-scale or have it a large scale. Ki yaar, ye karenge. Ab uske baad kya karenge? Ye bahut bada sawal aa jata hai. Because you become so good at something and suddenly it's taken away from you, right? And money just cannot replace that.
Yeah.
It doesn't. It will never. So even for us, when we think about Sauce, when people ask me, what is your dream for Sauce? My dream for Sauce is that Sauce is there when I'm 75, right? And I may not be sort of the managing partner or taking the cause, and there's a team which will take over, but I will have my relevance in some role that I play in founders' lives, right? And money stops being a part of that conversation. For so many successful peers of mine or seniors of mine from the industry, like, you know, Kaval ko dekh lo ab, I'm fairly certain it's no longer about
the money.
An incremental zero in the, how does it matter now? But the joy, and I had this conversation with him, he said, the joy I got out of, I was sitting at the Oberoi in Gurgaon with him, he said, yaar, is sofa pe baith ke, aadhe ghante mein Varun aur Ghazal ko maine offer diya tha. And wo jo, and that impact that has, you know, created and given birth to this beautiful company today, and to call it mine, right? For me to call Hocco mine, call Mokobara mine, it doesn't matter. What are we going to spend it on, man? Look at what we spend on, look at the lives we lead. Nothing incremental is now going to come.
Correct.
That can be bought. Money is important. It buys you comfort.
Yeah.
and it buys you a lot of things, but the incremental marginal utility,
it's good. It stagnates fully, upwards of a small amount.
And in India, a very small amount, actually.
But tell me about Hocco. Like, how did that start and how did you guys get together? And, you know, like,
so.
Because it's, I wanted to, that's the second question I wanted to unpack, is ice cream is a damn hard business. Yeah. So we're investors, by the way, in BarberShop. I put in some money and I had a lot of friends who would be like, ki, especially McKinsey guys, they didn't have time. They said, you anyways founder of the ecosystem. Mein.
And how you get access.
$5-10 lakh checks. Not like sizable, but not doesn't move the needle to a founder in general. Yeah. But I always felt that if I do more than that, then either I can reduce it a lot, or then, you know, I'll have to find a way to syndicate it. Then there were no vehicles in 2018. So I had a lot of friends who would be like, here, you if you're putting it, just put the same amount. If you're putting it, I'll take 5. So then I wrote a message to all of them in 2020-2021 that I'm starting this angel investing thing slightly at scale. And if you're able to come with me, I will sort of bring 10 lakhs, I can put 30-40 lakhs in a company, which will make it sizable. So we got together 25 crore rupees.
In nice.
Aray, 25 crore aa gaya, that's pretty cool. 80 log aa gaya, and people are like, Nikhil Vora, for example, said, chal, 2 crore from my side. I said, really? Wow, awesome. And then, so we invested in a brand called GoZero.
Yeah.
Okay, so Kiran Chawal.
Also, I am in Lucknow.
My badge, yeah?
Yeah. I just met him sometime.
He's
like,
the Apsara
promoter's family, and then he started GoZero. We invested. Arjun is again so happy with that company, and like Kiran Chade, they raised from World Invest and a couple of others. I think they're raising again. Kuch to chal raha hai. But uske saath hamesha baat karte hain to bolta hai yaar ice cream bahut difficult industry hai scale. Unilever, I think, has got heard some news that they're kind of demerging
their has their own problems. So I don't think it's an ice cream problem. It's a Unilever problem.
They're the largest.
They have to solve.
They're the largest ice cream manufacturer in the world.
Yeah, they have to solve. Far. They have to solve many other problems at Unilever.
Even Rohan, for example, first business was an
first,
ice cream.
I Lara doesn't know this. I put all my savings into Hokey Pokey.
Really?
Yeah.
It's a very similar name.
Hokey Pokey. Fir wo hua nahi. Even with the best team and all, it's a very difficult business.
Correct.
And usme kyunki usme the chilled product. को मैन्युफैक्चर करना उसका सप्लाई चेन मैनेज करना
आइसक्रीम उधर शायद मेल्ट हो रहा
है तो खा लेते
हो दैट इज वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड द रिटेल एंड ऑफ इट इज एक्सट्रीमली ब्रोकन बिकॉज छोटे रिटेलर क्या करते हैं वो रात को फ्रीजर ऑफ कर देते हैं बिजली बचाने के लिए और उसमें अगर आपका प्रोडक्ट बहुत सॉलिड नहीं है ना तो इट डेवलप्स दैट आइस क्रिस्टल्स
करेक्ट
that screws the product
the texture is gone
and then it when you return it it's basically waste.
Yeah.
So it's a very tough and thankfully Ron launched Epigamia, which turned out to be I would not be saying things like money doesn't matter and all that.
It's still
So I've twice gone all in life, ek bari into Epigamia and then into Fund One of Sauce. Really? Put all my savings in. Yeah.
You put all
your savings in? All. And two kids and you know abhi bataya maine. So we returned the full fund. अब लारा को बताया कि यार ये तो दूसरी बेशी लाइक तो व्हाट वर यू एंड व्हाट वुड यू हैव डन ऐसे उतना सोचा नहीं था कहीं नौकरी मिल जाता तो बट कोविड में बहुत मेरा तो हालत ऐसा वाला मी मैंने मेरा धक धक हो रहा था आई लाइक सब गया वो 17 इयर्स ऑफ वर्क एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट एनीवे इट ऑल टर्न आउट फाइन
But how did this happen? And
it's ice cream is still hard, so you can talk some more.
Yeah.
I don't want to check it. So look, for me, how did Hocco start was, so the naming was not important. I just wanted something with H. So actually Hocco, my last name is Chona. So Hocco stands for House of Chona.
Okay.
And वो HOC थोड़ा incomplete लग रहा था तो बोले उसके आगे CO का डाल देते हाउस ऑफ चोना collaborative company जो भी डालना so it actually means nothing and my inspiration was all these new age companies right easy to pronounce top of mind recall what is Swiggy what is Zomato you know they mean nothing you know so what's in a name right I mean okay you can what's Walls what's Wadilal you know
Hocco sounds cool
so it's just Hocco you know
yeah
so and yeah so The branding and all was a whole different story.
Yeah, आपसे मेरे को 2016 में बात करनी चाहिए थी, because ये मेरे को पता ही नहीं था कि एक दो सिलेबल का ब्रांड होना चाहिए। तो उन्होंने बना दिया 7 सिलेबल का बॉम्बे शेविंग कंपनी। अरे एक तो वर्ड ऑफ माउथ कम है।
तो BSC बोलते हैं ना सब।
But BSC also is very boring short form. It's very generic short form. So we have to live with a bad call. But
so So yeah, again, we created this brand actually before COVID. What happened is we sold the ice cream business. We were left with the restaurant business, which was also called Havmor.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I was like,
how many restaurants, how big was that business? Just give me a sense.
So we are about, between franchises and us, we are about 40 outlets. Okay. Now we are 100 outlets. So about 40% is company owned, 60. So about 40 are company owned, 60 are franchise.
Okay.
Mainly in Gujarat. And we have three brands there, but Hocco being the main brand there. So it is like, if you are in Delhi, you are like a Nirola's concept. Right? So imagine, but Nirola's with the FMCG, the distribution part being 90% of the business, this being actually 5-7% only. So we sold 95%. Then I was like, there's no point keeping your erstwhile name. You know, so let's change the name. While I was allowed to use it for up to a period of 10 years. So then we thought of some names, this, that and all. And that's how Hocco was born. And we rebranded all our outlets from Havmor to Hocco.
That's a big call, huh?
Yeah, and
that's
happened.
A big call.
It happened 4 months before COVID. So we just changed the name. Like, legally, I don't know if I'm allowed to say rebranded, but So we just changed the name to Hocco and the same product and all, but more focus on food. And then, as I said, when my non-compete got over, I worked with this very, very talented agency, again, thanks to Manu. A young bunch of Anushka Sani, young entrepreneur, amazing at her job. She'd done the whole truth work and all of that. I really liked it. Everybody liked whole truth and the way they were talking.
Yeah, so, that was also Anushka. And nothing else to hold.
Yeah, yes. So that whole thing they did, right? So I told Manu, I really want to work with Anushka. So he introduced me. And first meeting only, she was 3x the price of the one you were considering. My whole team wanted to go with the other one.
Gujju.
Gujju. No. See, she was 3x the price. There was no, obviously we negotiated a little bit, but we were very clear that, I was very clear that I put my foot down like this, where I vetoed everyone else. I said, I want to work with her.
Yeah.
And that time we not even said that we will use Hocco as a brand name. We said, we'll figure it out. And this is literally a non-compete that just gone over and all of that. And so this was like the first thing we needed, right? We need brand and all that. So she came on board and, first it went, I said, dekho, fatafat karo, 3 mahine mein. She's like, nahi, I have to peel the onion, what do we stand for, this, that, all. So we went through the whole meeting of 8 hours.
Exhausting.
And so I said, can I delegate this? She said, no, you have to be part of it. She got my dad in it, this, that, and all that. And that's how Hocco was born. So that's how the brand was born, right? But how we started was just that, we were still one of Havmor's largest ice cream purchasers, right? Because we were retailing it, but usme maza nahi aaya. Yeah. When you're used to manufacturing, we are used to running the brand ourselves, being just a retailer of that brand was, I just felt that, from there we've come down here. So we kept buying it. We were obligated to buy and all of that. So we did everything by the book as far as the law was concerned and our agreement was concerned. But when the 5 years were getting over, I said, yeah. And the fun we had running the ice cream brand earlier, that was missing. And I saw it in the current avatar of the brand also. While it was a 70-year-old brand, we did a lot of fun stuff. Like my dad would come back from Japan and say, chalo matcha ice cream banate. I said, koi khayega nahi. Arre, I don't care. He got those green tea something imported from Japan and wo abhi bhi pada hoga udhar, I don't know, I would come back from I came back from the US and said, I want to launch a peanut butter ice cream, So we did the whole Snicker bar kind of thing. It bombed, So, because literally in the Gujarat market, like, aato mungfadi no ice cream chahiye, So ye kon khayega, isme badam kidhar hai, pista kidhar hai, so it bombed. So we kept doing all of that stuff. We launched a whiskey flavor ice cream. So, all those things. When we launched Bombay, we launched a modak flavored, modak shaped ice cream. It was manually made. It took us like hours to make just a limited quantity, but we did it only for 8 days or 9 days whenever Ganpati time, yeah. Right? But that's the kind of stuff we did. And I was like, I need to do that again. And then I said, listen, and Manu again would keep saying, karna to. And then, you also realize you have your circle of competence. I'm not into health food. I'd launched a health food brand. I realized that's my wife's circle of competence. Restaurants I really enjoy, but I find it very hard to scale in India. If you think about it, there are hardly any brands that have gone pan-India. And then what I realized, there's such a big void in the market in India.
Insane.
Which was the last ice cream brand that was launched at a mass level. I'm not talking about what you just mentioned, Go Zero or any of these, health conscious or
a lot of those brands. Yeah.
Hardly. Even Hokey Pokey was a very premium, brand. Yeah. Our product started $5.
If you look at the market today, right, the average age of mass-priced ice cream brands. And a lot of people, a lot of my LPs also ask me, yeah, we're investing in this. You differentiate kaise karega ye wo? I said, boss, tum wo chhod do. We did a survey with consumers when we built our thesis. Not a single brand at mass was less than 50 to 60 years old. Amul, Mother Dairy, Wadilal, Havmor, aap koi bhi dekh lo. 60-70 saal purane brand.
And I think the last one would have been Dairy Day, which was about 20-25 years.
And
20
you
years.
Know, we have a simple concept of Sauce that there is a concept of generational brand fatigue.
Correct.
Even at XYXX, yehi hua tha, yaar. The insight we got from consumers was ki papa aur dadaji jockey pehen rahe hain. Ab main nahi pehnunga boss wo.
Same with Gillette and Mama John.
Exactly, same. Exactly.
And this generation actually wants to be different from their dad.
They don't.
I copied my dad on everything. Yeah. But this generation wants to be different.
Yeah. And therefore, when we surveyed consumers and we asked them, no, which is the ice cream brand that you relate yourself to? None. Zero. Zilch. They didn't. My kids, like I grew up having hot chocolate fudge, right? For me, it's. But only now. But Nirla's now only nostalgia, dude. Like my kids don't want to have it, even right. Though it may taste great. Unko naya chahiye. And
what do they have like when they want to have an ice cream?
वैसे तो वो कुछ भी खा लेंगे. Ice cream मिल जाए उनको, but they'll look for their own niche brands. अब वो खुद वो 10 साल का एक 12 साल का है. Sahil is on his phone all the time. He's 12. तो वो Zomato पे जाके खुद ढूंढेगा. And he'll look for अतरंगी flavors or something new or at least something new that he can talk to his friends about. They are so social in that sense.
Yeah.
कि he will never want to be seen eating Amul. Even if Amul का ice cream best है. Yeah, it's not going to happen. And that is not a premium thing. It is a mass phenomenon.
You think salience, for example, brands like our investors, Colgate, you know, Ponds, look at FMCG, mein, salience has passed through generations. Do you think it's going to break at this, the current 20-year-old?
I think the salience will remain. I think the relevance for a new generation of those brands will is... Top. Yeah, and I see that. So if you look at how we invest... We don't invest or we've not found success in just new breakthrough categories. We found success in Hold Truth. We found success in pet care with Super Tails. But baki hamare jo winners nikal rahe hain is Hocco Ice Creams, XYXX underwear with its Mokobara luggage, right? So, Bear Anatomy shampoos. They are very big established categories where incumbents are so big that there is no motivation for them. Like, why would, if you're Colgate, for instance, right? You are 60%. Like India, mein oral care is Colgate. Colgate is oral care. It's like that. What is the incentive if Bombay Shaving Company is 65% of men's razors? Why would you innovate, dude? Why would you cannibalize yourself? Yeah. Why would jockey innovate at all?
Yeah.
But the consumer's awareness, disposable income now want something new, and you're not going to do it. You'll never do it as a strategy. You'll never do it. Why would I kill my own business, man? So these guys will come. They will take share. They will grow up, and they'll grow very big.
Interesting thesis.
And people told me also when we were doing Hocco ice creams, ki yaar, kya bikega? Like, I said, bikega chocolate, bikega vanilla, bikega butterscotch. But I'm telling you, is brand ka zyada bikega kisi aur brand se, because iska look and feel, iska packaging, iska brand, iske parlors are going to be absolutely something which the new age gen wants. And so the way it's being marketed, the stuff that Roli is doing, gorilla stuff, like people dancing on the streets having Hocco ice creams, that's the shit this generation wants, yaar.
Yeah. A lot of learnings, right? I mean, so, you know, you've run, as I said, you have a legacy brand and all of that. So, you pick up where you left off. And again, coming back to the way we thought about starting Hocco was, we just missed innovating. We missed having, I mean, ice cream is such a fun product. And
it's a fun, high competitive.
Yeah, and you know, my children told me this. You know, I have two boys, similar to Manu, they're 9 and 13 now. My younger one has no memory of going to the ice cream factory and all. I grew up with that, right? So my biggest thing was, and my younger one loves ice cream. And I was like, I can't take this privilege that I had growing up. So what's my number one driver is my children and that excitement that they will have. So every time they come to Ahmedabad, they live in Bombay, but every time they come to Ahmedabad, I make sure I take them to the ice cream plant. And my last time, my younger one was like, Daddy, I have one wish. I said, what? I want to put my mouth under the ice cream machine. I mean, how cool is that? Right? Yeah. I said, no, you can't do that, but we'll figure something else out for you, you know? So I said, once I'll do as much ice cream around you and you can eat all of it that you want. And so it's just, you know, and
social, it's fun, it's tasty, like you look forward to it.
It's indulgence, yeah. It's a break.
I can't wait to eat this.
Yeah, I'm just...
let's do it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, you know, So, and that's the thing, right? You're talking about innovation and all that. Like, so these are some cool products, you know, that we've launched. I'll move all this stuff out of the way. Now, you know, the packaging, everything. So I'll show you some boss bar. So this is, it's still really hard because I got it in dry ice. But if I have to show you something really cool, right? I mean,
this is 70 rupees, is it?
Yeah, so this is, but here, I'll show you, which, look, this is $5.
Wow. Right? Yeah, 5 rupees cube?
Now, this is my favorite one. We just launched this. This is Jaljeera ice cream.
Nice, check it out.
This is like $10.
This Jaljeera ice cream?
Yeah. And then this one, this is $50. But this is a cake sandwich. You know, it's a regular sandwich, which we have that. But this is actually a cake sandwich ice cream. So it's a cake on board. We'll open it.
This is a phenomenal product.
But I want you to try it.
Yeah, renovation, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so look, this is American nuts cake. It is so bad that it's so good. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's got jelly, it's got nuts, it's got a cake, it's got jam. Like,
how much is this one?
$50.
By the way, guys, please help yourself.
Yeah, this is all for everybody. Yeah, it's not.
I feel like somebody feed Phil wala show then. He keeps calling Richard to have and his crew.
Read this flavor. This is also $70 or $80, I don't know, but it's called Choco Lychee.
Cool. Yeah, boss, so, yeah.
That's the one I want. Then you all see, you're talking
what is
about
Boss Bar.
It's just a subcategory. So it's.
Would you make Boss Bar bigger than Hocco on the brand?
Yeah, because, you know, it's, I mean, not Play, to put a plug great. For another, yeah. But it's like Magnum, right? So, you know, like how, this is the most premium bar.
You want
have.
To create some of these,
like,
brand identities.
Yeah. You know, so this is the whole Boss Bar category.
There's a Casada, right? Casada is Casada, man. It's a brand in itself.
I'll show you a Casada pack. I mean, that I have to give a shot. I don't. I hope I've got the shot. No, I don't.
And this is sold. Like, how do you sell this now? Like, how big is this? How are you selling it now?
So we launched in October.
6 months back.
6 months back. October 15th was the first day we launched. Our revenue projections have gone through the roof. So,
he's now, being extremely modest. I'll tell
this
you.
Summer, now it'll be.
We started full-fledged. Full-fledged began November. Abhi hum sirf 6 cities in Gujarat mein bechte hain, ek do in Rajasthan. That is it. Shantanu, this is the fastest growing consumer business in India's history. Period. There's nothing.
He says that. I
there's nothing. You tell me, 4 months, 100 crores in February. In February, which is a winter month.
100.
Which is a winter month.
Around 8, 10 crores a month. 9.
Yeah. In its fourth month.
March, we do 12.
And summer is not set. Summer is not set in. We haven't opened Delhi. We haven't opened Maharashtra. We haven't opened Rajasthan also.
Explain the channel mix a little bit. Like, how old is the channel?
General trade. 75-80% in general trade.
And kids are coming to general trade stores. How
kids
do you get
to
freezers?
Anyway,
no, we put freezers. We put our own freezers. We sell them, give them for free, give them a deposit. We are there across 2,000 touch points in Gujarat right now. We've got the best distributors on board. We knew exactly whom to get. That's where, you know, our know-how, our experience comes in. But the team is very experienced.
Any know-how, experience, goodwill. Let me tell you the goodwill the family enjoys. See, we've done offline distribution with a lot of other companies. You're doing it as well.
Correct.
Jitna hum logo ragadna padta hai to sit with a good distributor.
Easy.
First, we'll get the shit distributors. Then they will screw us over. Then you will realize that out of the 20 we signed, 3 are worth working.
Correct.
Then you convince them that we will invest. Right? Here, day zero, when you walk into one of the biggest distributors who's already got an existing danda, that is where the conversation starts because it's a 60-year journey. Yaar. Unke bachche jo hain, they've grown up with Ankit as a kid. So the trust, the respect, that is the starting point.
Is great, right?
And the product is great. And they've taken a bet on the product and the family to be able to create new age stuff. Joki khichega. Because yahan pe hum koi, there's no Shahrukh, there's no big guy where we're trying to spend to create pull. This is just industry goodwill where they're taking a leap of faith.
This is amazing. Right? Yeah. Great product, which has got legacy of expertise. You've gotten the brand right. Like, I completely agree. I think just figuring out the brand in terms of visibility. I think thoda freezer mein, how do you get the freezer brand?
Oh, you have to see the freezer branding.
Hai kya photograph?
Haan, hai na. Mere paas pura mera catalog. I'll show it to you in a second. Haan.
So, and then, superior product at affordable price.
Yeah, and I'll tell you the...
It's golden.
The huge kicker which is going to come in is quick commerce.
Look, that's the... You see this?
Oh, wow.
I'll show you the other...
Fuck, freezers are so boring nowadays.
Yeah,
so
see,
cool.
Look at this, the whole branding. Look at this. This is... Look at that. I mean, see, this is our mascots. We've not even got here yet. You see our summer campaign. It's called Hooked on Hocco. And it's just people chilling in a pool, eating ice cream. People like, their campaign is going to hit it out of the park.
Yeah, this, so, these mascots which Anushka created. Sure.
Look at this whole product range. Yeah.
That is so refreshing, right? I mean, this guy is sitting in the parlor. Ye mascot baitha rehta hai. Abhi wo dandiya hua tha jab. To ye itna mota sa golu, he was playing dandiya with everyone.
Tell me, look at that. This is just mascots chilling. Look, find your chill. That's, you know, so.
Find your chill.
Yeah. And the, you know, the big guys, abhi bhi wo kya kar rahe hai? They're getting in really good looking women.
Magnum.
With dripping. I mean, that's such a cliche. I mean, yeah, it doesn't connect with. And in fact, abhi, the new age consumer is anti-celebrities, yaar.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Check this out. So this is a...
What is this?
This is a strawberry cheesecake cone. We couldn't figure out... You know, the packaging, we should get complaints that it breaks. So we put it in a...
Blister
pack. And then we put it in this box. And then, yeah. So
we can do it, man. Any existing category, mein...
But food has been... Like, food brands have struggled to scale. By
food is incredibly
food is
hard.
Very hard
incredibly
to scale.
Hard. Yeah. Incredibly
it's
hard.
Shashank, talk about it. You talk about it. Very... Zero, etc. Not... This is very unique.
Yeah.
Like, you've got a lot of things.
Yeah,
Like, look, this is your classic cassata, right? Now, as boring a product, I mean, TK has been around, but you see the packaging, you see the way we've put it also. It's like, and we're going to improve this further, right? Look at that. So, it's like properly individually packed.
Wow. This is now ice cream now.
This is ice cream, yeah. So.
This is for the camera.
Yeah. Well, guys, please.
Look, I think in our case, in personal care, we know end of the day, fragrance, lather, packaging. Teen cheezon ko agar aap crack karo na, aap sabun bech rahe ho, body wash bech rahe ho, shaving cream bech rahe ho, foam bech rahe ho. Broadly, it comes on to fragrance, lather, packaging. If you can get these three right, your product at the right price point, your repeatability of the product is solid. Aapke case mein also, like, I think the mascot, etc. makes the category fun.
Yeah. It is a fun category, right? It's like, that's the thing, right? We wanted to do stuff that we've never done before. Like, be it, you know, talk to a younger generation of audience, you know, bring products that we've never... And this is just... The reason we haven't innovated 10x of this is because we are getting revenues that we never expected. So now whatever innovation we do will be post-summer. Because we just need to get through this summer. We made a lot of promises which we plan to fulfill. Be it to distributors, making sure there's no short supplies, you know, there's all of that happening. So...
But have you, like, explored Zomato, Swiggy, etc.?
So we met Albinder's team. Sab chalu kar rahe. But you know the thing is, abhi most important for the company is to be able to deliver its promises to its partners, which are distributors, because unka livelihood and unka dhanda is dependent on us.
Fill rates is
dependent on us supplying to them, because season miss ho gaya unka to. So for us, that is priority. A war demand, we never expected. Yeah, between you and me, we're at 6x of what we are forecasted. 6x of what we are forecasted. So it is a different challenge. Different challenge now to manage the factory. Because this is not something that
is
I can
a
store.
Factory, or yeah. This is made in one place?
One plant.
So we have a factory outside of Andhra, which now we're scaling up to a much larger
3x
level.
3x the capacity will be at next year.
So it's a different challenge. A good one to have, I think, but not. You can't fail on that. Yeah, but.
Wow. Guys, you want to take, like, I don't know if you want to change back to it, please?
Yeah, come.
Please,
yeah,
come, pick up an ice cream. Trisha, Vidit, guys, come pick up an ice cream.
Huh? Yeah, no. So, sure. I'm going to get all of them out here. So, but right now, this
very
rock solid. Yeah. So, this is a sugar free one, in case somebody's on line.
Tu laya, biscoff wala.
Biscotti. This is my...
Cone?
Yeah.
So you want the
take it. I haven't... Listen, there's another hazelnut mudslide also.
Hazelnut, there's also a cone.
Yeah, this is a classic kulfi, which is okay.
Huh? I didn't mean,
leave it for you guys.
Yeah, we're going to leave it behind. But just once it's out, then it needs to be...
Ek kasata bhi hai.
This you need to try for sure. That's like the biscuit. And check out this one. This is a matka kulfi. The most boring, like, you know, this.
How do you have so many SKUs, man? At 4 months old?
So that's the thing, right? Every new age brand that comes in with cups and tubs, because that's the easiest thing to make. and the cheapest thing to CapEx.
Okay.
We were very clear, we're not going to do that. I mean, lack of it, there's no pussyfooting here, right?
Yeah.
We're going all in. Because if you don't come out with a whole range, the probability of the distributor converting 100% is not there.
Mm.
You're right. There's also a product that is sold in assortments. Like,
right. I'm not going to...
Like in our case, for example, people are asking us now in Series D, what is your SKU concentration? Kya hai? What is your hero product? What is we need to create? But ice cream, I think, is a little bit like shoes.
Yeah, you need to see. So for the distributor, who's our customer?
There's still some inside, but I've just.
But yeah, I think just to see an entrepreneur build out such, I mean, scale and all, I think you've gotten it right. But to see you after selling like in such a big way, but still coming with this.
Coming up, yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And the enthusiasm you're showing for is amazing. It's a huge. You know, Ankit, like honestly, like we do this because we believe that people who are watching us are future entrepreneurs of India.
Sure.
And हमको ये लगता है कि इस एपिसोड को देख के अगर एक जना भी अपना नौकरी छोड़ के या फिर अपना यू नो जो भी कर रहे हैं वो छोड़ के खुद का कुछ करे इट बिकम्स वर्थवाइल टाइम फॉर थ्री आवर्स टू हैव स्पेंड टुगेदर राइट एंड दिस होल टीम एंड एवरीवन बट आई थिंक व्हाट गेट्स पीपल ओवर द लाइन इज ऑलवेज टू सी समवन एक्चुअली डू इट एंड डेमोंस्ट्रेट इट एंड दिस इज अमेजिंग टू सी
आइसक्रीम इज वन ऑफ द फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग कैटेगरी जिसका द यूज केस इज बिल्ड फॉर क्विक कॉमर्स एंड एवरी ऑर्डर इन समर 1 in 3 orders is carrying ice cream. It's insane. So this is a completely new channel.
It will grow.
I feel it's going to explode the category if a new age entrepreneur can crack it. And ये तो अभी हमने तो शुरू नहीं किया है. But we are best positioned to build this along with Blinkit, with Instamart and so on. Because हम जाके जो ये founders करेंगे ना इन लोगों के साथ बैठ के बैठे हैं अनीश के साथ बैठे हैं हिमांशु अरविंदर के साथ या फिर श्री हर्षा के साथ ये बड़े लोग तो अपने आइवरी टार से उतर के भेजेंगे किसी मैनेजर को बट यू नो ब्लिंकिट वांट्स टू एक्सपेरिमेंट ब्लिंकिट वांट्स टू डू एबी टेस्टिंग ब्लिंकिट वांट्स टू डू इंस्टामार्ट वांट्स टू डू ये हम करेंगे
यू नो व्हाट पीपल थिंक इन लार्ज कंपनीज दैट क्विक कॉमर्स शुड सिट अंडर मॉडर्न ट्रेड
बताओ
बिकॉज़ असॉर्टमेंट भैया अरे तुम पागल हो कंज्यूमर क्या सोच रहा है यार
आई फील इन आइसक्रीम कैटेगरी मॉडर्न ट्रेड contributed 1%.
Yeah.
It'll continue to contribute 1%.
Yeah.
But quick commerce can contribute up to 20-30%.
Yeah.
That's crazy, you know?
Think about it. Abhi bhi right now, like, so now what has happened, new thing, we just launched Bombay and Delhi on quick commerce, only 6 SKUs. But now everywhere I go, to any friend's house in Bombay, they're like, you ask, oh, wait, I'll order for you. I said, put your address in and I'll order it. So, and I get it and I make the children eat it so that they convert. And they all talk about these fancy, expensive brands. And I tell the guy, I say, listen, I'm going to save you a lot of money in the future because my product is 1/4, 1/5 the price of anything that you're eating.
I had Artist ice cream. Huh? Okay, Artist
is a great brand, right? Yeah. But it's $200 for one. So
yeah, Artist is also 150, 170.
Yeah. I mean, and I understand where they're coming from, right? That's a whole different category. Like, I have nothing but respect, but ice cream in India is about mass consumption.
Absolutely. Yeah. Do you know 3 brands have hit $1 billion in India?
3 brands?
Have hit $1 billion in India.
Okay.
You know which ones they are?
Fruity.
Thumbs up.
But in the thumbs same up. House. Thumbs up?
Yeah.
Sprite, Parle Ji.
Okay.
The 3 brands. Sugar.
Tino Sugar.
So, there is now a category.
Bahut, yaar, you look at, humne ek energy drink mein invest kiya hai.
Kaun sa wala?
We've just launched it in Panipat this month. Okay, only in Panipat.
कैसे ढूंढ लेते हो
it's called Rocket. बिल्कुल मास नाम है. Rocket. मतलब इतना उसका tagline is literally हर गुट में rocket. एक गुट में rocket. Something like that.
Wow.
And Runway is going to be the brand ambassador for that and so on. I don't know if I'm supposed to announce it right now. But month one only in Haryana. Net sale post GST 4.25 crore.
क्या बात है.
Month one. And you look at Sting, dude. Look at Sting.
Sting is crazy.
It's literally used to sell at $30, right? $30 में 50 crore का ब्रांड था, 20 रुपए पे 4,000 crore का ब्रांड बनने वाला है इन 4 years. It's so thumbs up. When we talk about it being 8,000 crores, is a 60-year-old brand. It's taken a really long time to get there. Sting will get there in 6 years. That is the new generation in India which is getting its high from. And मैं तो बोलता हूँ कि people ask me what's going on, like what happened. I say this is not replacing Red Bull. This is replacing Kenny. Because the awareness within blue collar and tier 2, tier 3 youth that it is harmful, you know, it's not. But you need that kick. Yaar, chai se wo kick nahi aata hai, boss. So, when you need to do a 16-hour, 18-hour Uber shift, how do you get going? I mean, it's crazy.
It's taken me 8 years to understand what kind of unlock can happen at the right price point.
Yeah. No, price to. No, right.
So that's, freezer mein rakhna padega, melt ho jayega. Because now the dry ice is also evaporating.
Ankit is going to be, oh no, he'll.
How was the ice cream, man? Really?
Lost.
But you know, your question, why 5 rupees? Because the 5 rupees thing, the price point, is going to get the consumer into our brand.
Yeah.
And then 50 rupees. And 30 honestly, rupees. And 20 rupees.
It might not only get the consumer in your brand, it might actually get the consumer in your category.
Yeah.
Because how penetrated is ice cream in India? At a household level, it won't be a lot.
See, the biggest, people ask me, what's your biggest competition? A cliched answer that Pepsi gave is, first is water, then is Nimbu Pani, then is chai. But for us also, if you think about it, our cliched answer is, you're fighting for deep freezer space.
Yeah.
Yes.
99% households in India have either 0 or 1 fridge.
Yeah.
Right? More than 99%. How many people have 2 freezers in their house? Yeah. No, nobody. First, you're fighting for, agar Gujarati ghar hai, toh pehle toh amaras hoega pure saal ka, phir udhar matar hoega, baraf hoega.
Correct.
Kuch na kuch aur unka non-veg ghar hai, toh chicken hoega.
Correct.
Ice cream doesn't find space only in the freezer.
Correct.
So that is your biggest competition.
Correct.
Right?
Inventory.
Which is also why quick commerce is.
Yeah. And that's why.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
And by this bite-sized stuff, like you will finish, you don't need freezer space.
Yeah, you don't
it need. Comes, like now I can have it.
So. But price is such a revelation.
Dude, I cannot tell you, man.
No, that is also my, I spoke to a lot of ice cream founders and all just to understand what's going on in the space and this. While, again, this vegan ice cream, low fat, low sugar, it's a great story. But the consumption is happening here. Right?
And by the way, my thesis on that is that it's not two different consumers. It's the same consumer who is having the whole truth, who's also having this. It's an occasion thing.
Yeah.
And I will still, while I'm aware, I will consume a healthy alternative in 2 out of 10 occasions, but it's not going to take me away from biryani and makhani dal and butter chicken, Hocco ice creams, get my thumbs up fix along with fried. Sab hoga. But yes, the number of occasions for healthy alternatives is increasing, but you don't hit.
He's making sure he's plugging in his whole truth.
No, I'm not doing that. I'm not doing that at all. I'm saying, but I was just finishing. But you don't hit this kind of scale so
but
quickly.
But do we have health? There's not a health.
There's no health.
There's happiness.
You had one with zero sugar, but one
yes.
sugar.
No. So I'll tell you what it is, right? You need to have the package, which is like you ek diabetes wale uncle ke liye, you keep your sugar free, your low fat, whatever it is. The thing, ice cream, why you say it's a very difficult business, it is more of a logistics business than even a brand business. Because it is an impulse product. Today, if you're on the highway, you're driving from, say, Delhi to Agra, you'll stop and you'll say, ice cream, you will not say, agar ye brand hai, toh hi main rukunga.
No.
Whatever is there, as long as it's a brand you recognize or you think that is, something that you would be happy, that you'd be okay consuming, you'll have it. So if the ice cream is not there, that sale is lost. So getting your product, now the only way you can do that with that precision is if you can offer the entire gamut starting from 5, 10, 15 rupee product. Then on top of that, if you create a separate niche premium brand or you do a vegan brand, they'll contribute. It's a good story to have, but it's not going to move the needle as far as the volume is concerned. And that is where most of the new age brands struggle, right? It's getting distribution, which is key. So it's not that sugar-free now will contribute to a decent amount of sales in the ice cream industry, but getting it out there is the challenge.
How to feel health, for example, like whole truth, etc. is there. Go Zero is there, whole truth. There's a lot of people, like I met Swasthi has come here from Yoga Bar.
Yeah.
I just sometimes, like we saw the 2 Yum story, right?
Yeah.
It was a tough story, a lot of capital and didn't like get to the level. I always feel health is a bit, are we 20 years behind on health? Like first the category has to penetrate, then more consumers have to want to pay more money for a better alternative. But this is like a, I want a craving.
I want to try that one also.
We're going to pile on 2,000 calories
by
the end of it. But, coming to your point, I think there is undoubtedly an increasing awareness towards healthier alternatives. When it comes to food, you still have to be tasty and right priced. And then health is certainly a third consideration coming in. But our view is that it's the same consumer who's making that. Aisa nahi hai ki there are, it's a very small sliver of consumers who are saying ki main ice cream khaunga hi nahi because it is unhealthy. Wo bahut kam hai. Bahut log hain jo keh rahe hain ki haan ab main, you know, I'll have my protein bar, I'll have my protein intake through the day, I'll do my workout. But guess what? I'll have an ice cream or share one with my wife at night after dinner. So, wo ho raha hai. I think, therefore, you'll see on the health side, you'll have to build brand first. Because to own that narrative of that ultra-aware consumer, to be able to build trust there and have that deep conversation there, it has to be a brand first, very, very brand first in the mix. Here, it's an incredible distribution. I don't need to tell a consumer ki chopo bar kya hoti hai, kasata kya hoti hai. Wo sab hume awareness creation or trust building nahi karna hai.
Categories are.
Categories are a large category.
Hume apna product better than others banana hai. We have to continually keep innovating with novelties, which is what this guy is doing really well. On the packaging, on the kind of products he's coming out with. And just keep hitting distribution, serving it really well. Nurture that relationship with distributors. Build those as businesses. Ultimately, they are our customers first, actually,
yeah.
In a way. And you do that, you build that trust, you get that equity in the market. Trade supports you so well into making something large.
What you said is very interesting, right? Ice cream is one category where, for me, the retailer is my customer. Because unlike the West, where modern trade is, you know, here, you go and ask, ice cream mein kya hai? You're not opening a deep freezer and picking out the ice cream yourself. Mm-hmm. And 99% of the locations. Like, and as I said, again, in modern trade, there's hardly any sale happening. So the shopkeeper is deciding, ki ye achha hai, ab ye try kiya. So for us, the reason why Hocco is successful is because, like you said, the goodwill that we have, the people that we have. So his pitch is very clear that this is launched by the Chonas who have known ice creams. You know, so try it. It's a new age brand and it's different. And it's probably the way ice cream should be. You know, we're not cutting corners and, you know, we're actually making it as indulgent as we possibly can.
Is this a ice cream? Is this a frozen desert?
It's ice cream.
Always.
Milk-based.
We've never done, even in a swell company, even now, that was our biggest USP that we make, you know, before even Amul came into the picture, Havmor always milk-based ice cream. This is also very clear that Hocco is going to be milk-based.
But, I mean, the team super obsessed with the product, huh? Like, I have seen it where, of course, it impacts margins. If I put an extra kaju or I put 0.5% more milk fat, right? But zero compromise on that. Zero matlab?
That is one thing that my dad told me. Right? You know, when I was, so, there's a whole story where, like, so my dad, right? I mean,
Pradeep, sir.
Yeah. So,
my tongue has become a little heavy, like, so cold down.
We'll do the talk. I'll do the talk in the next 2 minutes. Then. So, he's, you know, He's come full circle, right? First, after he sold the business, he was happy. He was the one who was content. He's like, "Theek hai, achha kiya. Life mein stress kam hai. Restaurant business hai. Wo, you know, good enough to keep him busy. Not good enough to keep both of us busy."
So, do you have siblings?
I have a sister. But she's not involved in the family business. She lives in the US.
Okay.
So he was like, I told him that, you know, I want to start ice creams again. He said, "Are you mad? What's wrong with you?"
But said, why did he say that? Because he thought it's hard and so on?
He's like, "You chill, yaar, enjoy life. I've done this." I said, "But dad, this time, that 75-year journey, I will finish in 7.5 years. That was my motivation. I said, "Ito saare 7.5 saal mein karna hai. Karenge ke nahi? It's only been 5 months, but we've caught up at least the first 30, 40 years, I think, in 5 months. So, So he said, "But why do you want to do it? Enjoy, you know, do something which is not, you know, as hard as ice cream." I said, "Anything else will be harder only for me, you know, because the circle of competence and his." So I told him also, I said, "I don't want you to get the stress of that business, but I need your mentorship and I need your blessings." He said, "That you always have." So when he started, first he's like, "Theek hai, tu kar raha hai, par dekh lena, this and all." Now also his biggest, he's my biggest, number one critique, number one cheerleader. As family, both parents, I mean, my mom was always that, "Nahi, tu kar, tu achche se karega," all that. But dad is like, every time we'll taste a product also, he'll always have feedback. Yeah. And that's what the DNA of our business has always been that, you know, how can you make it better? How can we make sure that there is zero defects? There is, you know, something. So, and we're constantly working on that. Like even right now, when you're eating the ice cream, I'm only looking, okay, the stick should have been a little more outside. And, you know, so.
You think the same.
A great product is differentiated from a good product in only very subtle ways. Yeah, I would go ahead.
Yeah. So that's what I'm saying. So for us, you know, what is missing in the industry right now is that innovation, that fun with ice creams, and that obsession with quality. You know, what has happened is because there's been no challenger coming in, everybody's just been milking it for profits. I can tell, right? It is like, so, you know, wo kaju kishmish, Gujarat mein we call it kaju draksh. Kaju is supposed to be 70%, kishmish is supposed to be 30%. Okay, then every year, all companies, suddenly you see, okay, 40%, then the ratios keep changing every year to cut cost, right? So we were very clear that, yeah, no, what is meant to be is what we'll keep it at. There's a reason why it was like that, you know? So there's a small difference. Yes, it increases the cost by a few percentage points, and obviously it will impact margins, but we'll figure that out. I think once people get the hang of our ice creams, they believe in it, they trust in it, we can probably do that 5% premium they'll be willing to pay. And right now, also for a new brand, you know, to reach where we are, everybody's eating our ice cream with a lot of scrutiny.
Yeah. You're under the lens, for sure. Is it as good? Is it better?
That is creaminess, so true. And I was thinking
creaminess.
That. Yeah. So I'll tell you what ice cream I have been loving for the last few, maybe a year or so. There's a brand called Nick, N-I-C.
N-I-C, yeah.
And there's Naturals. I'm a Pune boy. So for me, Naturals, I grew up with tender coconut and alfalfa mango.
I should have got a tender coconut. It's better than natural. In a blind taste, it is there, yeah.
So I was like, I grew up with that. Yahan pe bhi blinker mein milta hai, toh yaar, it's always in my freezer.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, yaar, next time if I'm ordering, then a few days back, we had an artist. You know Prachi Pawar at Peak 15?
Yeah, yeah, of course.
She's one of my best friends.
She's very close to me as well, yeah.
And Prachi like got an artist and like, I love that. But it's very mehenga. So I was thinking, yeah, compared to what I've had in the last few days or few months, how do I compare? It's a subconscious thing that you will do.
So, I mean, I have great respect. Naturally, one of my favorite ice cream brands in India. Even when I used to run Havmor, even now, like I still feel that the way they've been disciplined about doing what they do and not caring about what's out there is something that is incredible. But, so what has been happening is that every person who's coming to our store, you know, is used to having certain ice cream, now they're having a new brand. So the feedback, nobody, when you used to eat, again, have more ice cream, nobody used to message me. Today I tried your ice cream, it was really good. But now, every day I get at least 10 people message me because we're selling that much ice cream and people are obviously consuming it. And so the feedback that we are getting is so fast. And here's the thing, right? Even on our website, on our packaging, whatever the email address, that email comes to me. So if there is any issue, you know, we address it right then and there. And that is what something we've always done, even in our restaurant business, every company that we've run in the past. And so we take every feedback very... In fact, when he was eating the ice cream cone, I could not hear the crunch. So I'm going to ask him later, was it crunchy or no?
Was it?
It was.
And
it had a chocolate coming.
But was it crunchy or was it soggy?
It was crunchy.
I was hoping I'd hear the crunch. So I kept looking at him, what crunch? Abhi tak he did not reach the cone part. So because that is very important, right? Your cone has to be crunchy. And sometimes it doesn't. Obviously, we are a startup. There are mistakes that happen, you know. So, but learn something.
I mean, I think your point, which is the subtle difference between good and great. And so many founders in their journeys get so impacted from the outward in, which is, boss, kya case going up? Mereko discount karne padega. I need to go into BOGO. I need to go. Warna sale nahi aayega. Ye nahi aayega. I mean, if there's one journey I can share where the obsession with product was so insane, is apna luggage wala, you know, Okubara. Like, I have seen those guys so obsessed with every aspect of their product. Even when they launched their first store, the co-founder Naveen, all he was doing was, agar ye light hai, to ye is exactly 23.5 degrees mein hona chahiye. So that display mein uska front, bilkul front ka bag ka shine aisa dikhna chahiye. Aur window mein sirf glossy wale, andar sirf matte. That level of obsession is what ultimately, and in Mokubara's journey as well, and I just want to share this with founders, it is not written in any rule book that with scale your ROAS is going to drop. If you build a product that consumers desire and it lives up to that promise, consumers will talk and they will spread word of mouth, and they will do so in a fairly fast fashion. Yeah. It doesn't take very long. I have seen Mokubara's ROAS on their website go from 2 to 6.5.
Wow.
And it has stayed, and every quarter it is going up as they are scaling. So
I'll tell you why I think that's happened. And I was thinking about this the other day. Nidhi is the Indigo Edge partner who's running our deal. Every time I meet her, she's with a new Mokubara bag. And dude, too bada brand ambassador banti Mokubara ka, like deal chala rahi hai. Then nahi, mere ghar mein 19 Mokubara ke products hai. So when you have high AOV, repeat customers, then you're home.
Yeah.
You're
home. You know, ye sab jo VC ke metrics hai na, repeat, main tujhko sach mein bata raha hu, you know, I'll tell you, I won't name the fund. An analyst came in when we were trying to raise a Series A. By the way, no one participated in the Series A at Mokubara in April 2023. It was done by Sama and us. It was an internal round. They struggled to raise in April 23. By July 23, they had 7 term sheets incoming without running a process. Otherwise, Nidhi would have run the process. Anyway, so the story there is, you build something that people want, yeah. And that is the fundamental, you know, if you genuinely build something that people are craving, every other equation around price, around everything, totally goes out of the window. And that is the starting point for a founder to think about, have I built something consumers are going to crave so much, and it will satisfy their craving so much that they talk to others about it. Yeah. Baki to sab, because ultimately we're trying to disrupt them. We're not competing with each other.
Correct.
Moko is trying to disrupt the Samsonite. Yeah. It is not competing with the other great guys. And a lot of my LPs reach out saying, yeah, what do you think about assembly luggage, for instance? I said, yeah, it's great. And wo banayega boss. Wo, I met that founder. Bahut achha ladka hai. Kuch achha banega wahan pe.
Correct.
It does not. And they're like, will it compete with Mokubara? I said, absolutely not. Mokubara is not competing with assembly. It is competing with the... We all are competing with the big daddies out there. The market is out there. Correct. We're not... And so, you know, during the Series A, I remember one analyst, must be in his early 20s, he comes and talks to Sangeet on the call, and he's like, ki yaar, iska, please tell us the LTV CAC.
Fuck, yaar.
So Sangeet
I
was like...
I hate that question on the bottom of my heart.
Sangeet's response was, ki yaar, I don't want to do this call, get someone else. He said, no, but you know, it's a very important, extremely important metric for this deal to go forward. He said, this deal ain't going forward. I'm telling you, it ain't going forward. He said, no, but it's a very important metric for us, Fund X. He said, I don't care. This is not at all important for us. Yeah. It may be for you. And it's possibly a great metric for SaaS. But he said, but you know, it's a great metric for you as well as a business. He said, yeah, I sit in and listen to earnings calls of Safari and VIP. Why don't you come on the next one and ask the Safari management, what is your LTV back? So, pooch usse aur wo tere ko kya jawab deta, tu mere ko bata. I don't want to. So the issue, and you know, I also understand that funds we raise karne hai, so you have to listen to this nonsense. But the North Star has to be build something consumers really want. Think about how you can disrupt the big guys. Those two things you work, you can build something really big. Don't get into
LTV by CAC is a very, it's a very, first of all, it's a mono dimensional metric for D2C, number one.
What is long-term value, long-term value of a customer.
Lifetime value.
जो भी. And एक और होता है बहुत बढ़िया metric, which is repeat. A lot of metrics that VC investors focus on, and a lot, I'd say that many of the VCs are also looking at it very well intentioned, because they have a certain framework of looking at businesses. A lot of that is influenced by frameworks built for the tech industry. Right, and does not necessarily lay itself well into a consumer brand business. Right, so this LTV by CAC is correct. One such.
Correct.
The other one, which is extremely challenging, and I know where they're coming from, is to look at repeat metrics. Right, so looking at repeat cohorts and so on. Bahut mushkil hai. And I can tell you from the biggest CPG firms, and you read the best literature on brands and brand businesses and so on, they don't look at repeats till you're at a significant scale where you're plateauing. because repeats then becomes a driver for it. The initial phase, and for a very long time in a brand's business, is customer acquisition. And the other big issue I have is measuring repeats in an omni-channel universe that we live in. It is virtually impossible because many of these channels are just being used for discovery, especially D2C, which is a channel at best for connecting with your consumers, cannot ever be the second repeat channel ever because you'll always get the same product you've already tried on Amazon or Blinkit much faster. So they will buy there, they will go to a general trade. Agar tumhe chakli hai product, tumhe pasand aa gaya, then it's all about price and convenience. Uske baad discovery ya kuch nahi ho raha hai. To usko to aap capture nahi kar sakte. You cannot therefore overlay. So what do we look at, right? And what I tell founders to obsess about is the derivative of all of this, which is CM2. Ki aap bhai paisa nahi kharch kar rahe apna maal bechne ke liye. Maal bechne ke baad aap paisa bana rahe. That is the ultimate truth and metric because once you're CM2 positive, then as you scale, you will meet your fixed costs and you will be profitable. And that's the holy grail. Bas itna dekhna hai. But wo kahi conversation in cheezon mein lost ho jaati hai. Ki repeat velocity nahi hai, ye nahi hai, wo nahi hai. But theek hai. I mean, that's the delta for us to make juice on it.
So LTV CAC is important because it when you only sell, for example, dollar shape plan.
Yeah.
Our D2C business, subscription business, US mein like 300 million tak pahunch gaya tha, Unilever bought over a billion. And it was like mathematical poetry. Right? LTV CAC, ki ek bar customer ko acquire kar liya. Whatever it was, $10, $15 में, फिर वो आपसे हर महीने $4 का product ले रहा है, and if your drop-offs are let's say 10% every month, over a period of time, you're able to make for every acquisition, you're able to make $40, make $50 of contribution margin, right? So $40 is your LTV, and 3 साल का LTV usually मान लेते हैं, उसके बाद usually you don't calculate it. 3 साल का LTV upon CAC is a ratio of 4-5 you will consider, and वहाँ पे उसके model में वो इम्पॉर्टेंट है उस एनालिस्ट के मॉडल में क्या रहता है क्या 4 है 5 है 10 है 2 है वट एवर इट इज राइट. अब हमारा धंधा ब्लिंकिट पे भी बिक रहा है, हमारा D2C पे भी बिक रहा है, हमारा रिलायंस डिमांड में भी बिक रहा है. नाउ माय टीम इज स्ट्रगलिंग कि उसके मॉडल में वो जो नंबर
वो नहीं होगा, वो नहीं होगा.
अब तो आप यू आर राइट, नाउ यू लुक एट मार्केटिंग एफिशिएंसी. तुम ब्रॉडली ये देख लो कि परफॉर्मेंस टू नेट सेल्स या परफॉर्मेंस प्लस ब्रांड टू नेट सेल्स इज दैट नंबर गोइंग, आर यू स्माइलिंग डाउनवर्ड्स ब्रॉडली. तो एफिशिएंसी आ रहा है क्या, CM2 पॉजिटिव है क्या, बिकॉज ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड देन यू हैव सम इनटैंजिबल मेट्रिक्स कि तुम्हारा टोमा क्या है, तुम्हारा कंसल्टेशन क्या है, तुम कंज्यूमर तुम्हारे बारे में क्या बोलता है, ब्रॉडली सैम्पल कर लो 100 कस्टमर को रिपीट है कि नहीं, राइट. एंड इवन लैटरल रिपीट इज ओके कि तुम एक प्रोडक्ट खरीद रहे हो फिर उसके बाद 2-3 और खरीद रहे हो तो तुम लोड कर रहे हो पैंट एक्सेट्रा, बट बियॉन्ड दैट इज वेरी
वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कैप्चर. इट्स ऑल्सो द रॉन्ग मेट्रिक एज ए गाइडिंग सॉर्ट ऑफ नॉर्थ स्टार फॉर ए फाउंडर.
करेक्ट.
तुम उस पर कॉन्सेंट्रेट करने लगे तो यू मिसिंग आउट पॉसिबली ऑन ए फार लार्जर अपॉर्चुनिटी इन ओपनिंग अ न्यू मार्केट फॉर कस्टमर एक्विजिशन.
सो लेट मी टेल यू अंकित, लाइक जब यू शोड यू ऑल राइट, आई वांट टू एंड आई वांट टू शो यू एंड मनु, यू आर लाइक अ एक्सपर्ट इन द कंज्यूमर स्पेस एंड योर फ्रेंड इज लाइक द हार्ट एंड सोल ऑफ थिंक द थॉट ऑन दिस ऑल्सो राइट. सो वुड वांट टू शो राइट, हमारा जो दिस इज बेयर बिफोर 3-4 मिनट्स ओके. Bombay Shaving Company and Bombay are two brands. Fundamentally are in the business of hair removal. हमको ये लगता है कि hair removal used to be a service-driven experience. It is moving to products. Shaving, for example, India has 38 crore shavers, of which now 25 to 26 crore shavers do it on their own. Earlier, 25 to 26 crore shavers would go to the Nike dukaan. So 70s, 80s to the original barbershop. Sure. Yeah. But now they're almost 80% of shaving has now moved towards the bathroom. People do it on their own. Hair removal for women is still a 80 to 90% service driven. Parlor or salon mein jaake waxing karati hai ladies. But younger women, if you see the 20-year-old lady today, she'll probably have a razor in her purse.
But yahan
pe incumbent nahi hai, yahan pe incumbent hai. The Gillette is a fantastic product. I respect them very deeply, right? लेकिन हमने ये सोचा कि मोनोपोलाइज इंडस्ट्री है और हमारा रीजन टू एग्जिस्ट ये है कि बाथरूम में जो सिंक है ना, सिंक में जो मग्गा है जहाँ पे टूथब्रश टूथपेस्ट और रेजर होता है, वो हमारा स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट है. दैट इज द सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी ऑफ आर रीजन टू बी फॉर द कंज्यूमर. वहाँ हम रेजर डालते हैं, उसके बाद रेजर के बाजू में शेविंग क्रीम शेविंग फोम डालते हैं और ऊपर जो कैबिनेट है नीचे जो कैबिनेट है वहाँ पे हमारा ट्रिमर और वैक्सिंग स्ट्रिप्स एंड कपल ऑफ अदर थिंग्स. सो आर विजन इफ यू सी इज 2-5-10, 2 करोड़ बाथरूम, 5 प्रोडक्ट पर बाथरूम, 10 मिनट्स ऑफ हैप्पीनेस. आपके बदन से अगर बाल आपको निकालने हैं तो बॉम्बे शेविंग कंपनी एंड बॉम्बे आर द डिलाइटफुल वेस्ट टू डू इट.
श्योर
ओके, दैट्स व्हाई वी वांट टू. Now you could be like, you are, like, look at this room, the three of us. You're a clean-shaven man who probably shaves 3 to 4 times a week. You're a stubble person, so you probably shave either once a month or you use a trimmer. And I clean shave my head and my face, but I like to trim my goat.
Sure.
And if you see people who are 18, 19, look at Ishan Kishan and Shubman and Shreyas.
Yeah, yeah.
The new age guys are a combination of trimmer, razor, and even women are like this, right? Now, the center of gravity is razor. Sabse bada category hai, sabse core hai. Aur wahan pe matlab usage hai. You don't have to teach. It's like, ice cream kya sikhana nahi padta. Category penetration is clear, right? Lekin, the good part about taking on an incumbent, which very few people realize is, they're mostly... Their monopolies means they're unsegmented brands.
Yeah, absolutely.
Whether it's poor or rich, young or old, dry skin or sensitive skin, etc., etc. Har ek aadmi ko wahi bechte ho tum. Ta like cool, unsegmented brand hai, matlab wahan pe jagah pakadni aasan hai. Right? Because we can segment ourselves, number one. Number two, ki what is the best time to catch someone? Hum teen log hain, agar humne, like we are in our 30s or 40s, if you have, we have probably been using Gillette for
12 years. 15 is the age or 16 is the age.
So you, I'm like, you have 28 saal ke up, aadmi, matlab 10 saal Gillette use kar raha hai, to usko remove karna difficult hai. Lekin 17, 18 saal ki umar, jab pehli baar wo shave karega, and mooch nikalne ke liye, sideburn nikalne ke liye, fir daadi ko shave karne ke liye, you have to give that guy an option. At that point, he wants to use a product that is not his father's razor.
Yep.
I'm like, cool, give him a younger brand. So, younger brand, more Indian and some, you know, cues that are more rebellious, outlaw, challenger, vibrant. And what is that person's requirement? That person's requirement is that his skin is sensitive. Acne hai, beard ko shape karna hai. Uske requirements are different from a regular Gillette clean shaver. I said, cool. Unsegmented hai, to clean, young, 18, 19-year-old Bombay Shaving Company. And product superiority through sensitive skin. Now, that's now what is the third big Achilles heel of Gillette in India? कि 99 रुपए में प्रोडक्ट
है ही नहीं है नहीं
इंडिया स्वीटेस्ट प्राइस पॉइंट इन पर्सनल केयर दे डोंट हैव एन ऑफरिंग बिकॉज़ यू पुट अ 99 रुपए जस्ट लाइक यू सेड यू विल कैनिबलाइज अ मार्क 3 यूजर तो कर ही नहीं पाते हो
व्हाट इज देयर प्राइस पॉइंट
250
249 इज द मॉडल इज की रेजर को महंगा बेचो फिर ब्लेड्स को
हां ₹25 में सुंदर सा प्रोडक्ट है वो सिंगल ब्लेड सिस्टम रेजर 5-6 crore है इंडिया में लोग जो रोज गार्ड को यूज करते हैं 6 crore लोग
एज अ सिंगल ब्लेड
सिंगल ब्लेड बट द कॉम्ब एंड सिस्टम सो कार्टेज ₹25 का देन देयर आर कपल ऑफ वेरिएंट्स फ्रॉम 2500 बट द नेक्स्ट बिग प्रोडक्ट इज मार्क 3 सो लैडरिंग अप फ्रॉम अ गार्ड टू मार्क 3 इज अ ट्रिकी प्रोसेस वो होता नहीं इतने आसानी से मार्क 3 जनरली महंगा प्रोडक्ट इट्स वर्थ इट बट इज महंगा राइट लेकिन सो नाउ वी नो सेगमेंट कर सकते हैं उसमें सेंसिटिव स्किन एक्ने के लिए कर सकते हैं और 99 रुपए में बड़ा वेकेंसी है जो कर सकता है सो देख अर्जुन के साथ बैठा है ये है एंड अर्जुन ओनली कैन काइंड ऑफ टोल्ड अस कि दिस सीम लाइक द राइट प्लेसेस सो दिस इज व्हेन वी लॉन्च्ड आवर रेंज ऑफ सेंसी रेजर्स ओके सो हमारा ये था कि यार हमको ना वैल्यू और एस्पिरेशन दोनों देने हैं कंज्यूमर को तो 20 रुपए का प्रोडक्ट हो 600 रुपए का प्रोडक्ट हो उसको ये अगर आदमी 4 lakh का मारुति ऑल्टो खरीद रहा है ना उसको उस गाड़ी में भी अपने लिए मे बी इट्स अ मास अफोर्डेबल कार बट उसको उस गाड़ी में प्रीमियम फीलिंग चाहिए एसी अच्छा चाहिए म्यूजिक सिस्टम
ही इज अपग्रेडेड फ्रॉम अ टू व्हीलर मे बी और व्हाटएवर
उसमें नहीं इट्स फर्स्ट कार इट्स फैमिली कार सो ही इज गोना टेक हिज किड्स एंड ऑल आउट सो ही इज लाइक यार मेरे को उसमें प्रीमियम चाहिए लाइक प्रीमियम नहीं कर सकते लाइक प्रीमियम कैन नॉट बी प्राइसिंग प्रीमियम हैज टू बी एक्सपीरियंस एंड वैल्यू लगना चाहिए यार मेरे को 3-4 चीजें तो मिल गई इस प्रोडक्ट में सो फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू सी आर 20 रुपीज इट्स अ लड़ी यार मतलब इट सिट्स लाइक दिस इन अ रिटेलर स्टोर Like, Haldira Mungdal But if you, it's a 20 rupee product called Sensi Stud. So, jaise aap bolte na, Rocket. So, I'll give it to you. Is price point mein Gillette ka product nanga aata hai. It's a blue product, which is not packaged.
Only the top is just...
Only the top is correct. Same one. The one you get in a hotel.
Yeah.
Right? At this price point, we give a fully packaged one. And the issue with the product that is does not have packaging is it becomes dirty. This is a clean beige look. It's got a swivel head, which does not exist at 20 rupees, and it's got an aloe strip. So, three features at the same price point, sold in a kirane ke dukaan. So, now this is, and sensitive. So, Sensi stud for a 20-year-old.
And this is a twin blade.
Yeah, two blades. Presto is also two blades.
As aloe vera and vitamin E.
So, banda pehli baar shave kar raha hai, 20 rupees de raha hai, lekin bol raha hai ki, yaar, you are taking sharp metal to my face.
Yeah.
Do a good job with it.
Super.
Right? Then we have a 99 rupee Sensi Smart 3. This is now we are selling almost 1500 razors a day.
Oh, wow.
We did a reality TV show on the Barbershop called Razorpreneur.
This is the Mark 3.
So this is not a Mark 3 product. The Mark 3 is a way better product.
But it looks...
But it's... Exactly. So you get a Mark 3 type product at 40% the price.
What's the difference?
This is a handle is...
Plastic.
Lot lighter.
Plastic.
It's a lot lighter. Okay. But you get three blades. Great blades and a sensitive...
And you can change the blades. And so
Absolutely.
This is use and throw.
This you can use 4-5 times. This is a hotel in Malay. Right? Now, we also feel that at the Mark 3 and the Fusion price point, we want to give our consumers solutions, right? So, Sensi Flow 4 and Sensi Flow 6. At the Mark 3 price point, you get 4 blades instead of 3. But the tricky part is, men at that age want to shape their beard. Someone like me wants to get this line right. So, we have 1 blade on the back to get it right. Sensi Flow 6. 6 blade instead of 5, 1 blade on the back. Okay? The handle of Sensi Flow 4 and Sensi Flow 6 is the same. So, laddering from Mark 3 to Fusion requires changing the handle.
Mm.
3 blade to 5 blade, you have to change the handle. Everyone has to change the handle. The other thing we do, I don't know whether it's there in this particular SKU. The sharpener. It's not there in this. But we actually have, these are like protos, but we have a razor sharpener, which is this thing.
Okay.
It's there in every now.
Sharpener.
Now, usse, clinically, 70% life of razor goes up. Okay, it's a denim patch which you put in your bathroom and you rub the razor. Saaf ho jata hai, blades get exposed and you're able to create 70% excess life. But the 20-year-old consumer, maybe your sons might reach there soon, they'll be like, aap sharpener de rahe ho, toh iska matlab aapka profit kam ho raha hai. Kyun kar rahe ho aap? Right? They have this, I'm smart, I will ask questions point of view. And our answer is always on pack, etc. Communication is, ki we want to do what's right for your pocket. We want to do what's right for the environment. We hope that you like the sharpener. You can use it on your other razors as well. But if you like it, come and buy other stuff. So we are okay with the category shrinking because we are like, we don't want to be a razor company. But through our razors, we want to communicate why we are a great grooming and hair removal company. And these small things, yeah. So now if you see the shelf throw, vibrancy, etc.
Yeah, just see
the way the product holds.
You recently done a rebrand, right?
Yeah.
Because it looks very different from the OG.
Super.
Yeah.
And choti choti cheeze. So like this people.
What's the one behind that, the 700 rupee one?
Well, that's a Sensi Flow Lux.
That looks fancy.
Yeah, it's very cool. It's a very cool product. It's like. Do you like
electric, this thing?
No. Do you like fountain pens?
Oh, yes. Okay. I have, yeah. My dad is obsessed with all of these stuff.
Oh, so. I'll give.
Yeah, the one that hang. You know, silver this.
He uses a brush and all.
He uses a brush. There's this proper store in the US where you... It's by Gillette only. It's a premium brand.
Yeah. Art of shaving.
Art of shaving. Yes.
It's a beautiful product.
Yeah.
But it's whole decency. 600 rupees. It's not super expensive.
Mm. And you customize it.
Yeah, we'll write your name on it.
Damn cool.
D2C में वही है, engagement है. आपको नाम लिखवाना है, gift देना, उसको gift wrap करेंगे, अच्छा सा, बढ़िया सा gift देंगे. Also, for example, we are now going to replace Gillette in every Taj hotel. Starting
here. Nice.
Issue क्या है Taj? बंदा razor लेके जाता है. Usually, most men have their razor. They forget the foam or the cream or whatever. Bulky to carry. वहाँ पे आपको मिलता है, वो mustard, ketchup के sachet की तरह होता है gel. वो गीले हाथों का खुलता नहीं है. Okay,
very difficult.
Doesn't open. Now, we are like, how do we solve it? So Taj told us, yeah, aisa product banao jo chori ho jaye room se. Chori karne layak product banao, shaving kit tabhi milega. Hum yaar aapka ek to budget itna kam hai, usme humko aap bol rahe ho, but like 2.5 lakh room night hai. So like yaar important hai. It is not a big account, but it will create serious
huge brand building account.
These are gel, just hold it and I'll open it and show it to you. It's like a rigid credit card form factor.
Yep.
Aur aise khulta hai. Oh, phew. Do breaks into half.
Ah, okay.
And squeezes out.
Nice. It doesn't come on your fingers.
No, it's fully dry. And you no wastage.
Nice.
So again, good to great. Like now, this is kya hoga iska mere ko koi idea nahi. To be honest.
Yeh maine Japan mein dekha tha, where they dispense soy sauce at a sushi bar.
Correct.
Oh.
Correct. This is how like Japanese packaging is
awesome. It's insane, yeah.
So for us, we're like, you know, the good to great jump, we will put all our effort. And as an entrepreneur, I'm sure like you've also done the same thing with your ice cream. You'll see it probably with all your founders. Ki choti choti cheezon mein humko insight milti hai. Aur un choti cheezon ko hum firm pe bada karne ki koshish karte hain. Now, here we're seeing almost, oh, this is easy to measure repeats, right? Because you're selling like Flowfor ka cartridge kharida hai, toh repeat hi hai. Matlab, there is no way. This is a first time customer.
Yep.
So repeats are now touching 35-40%.
Nice.
So for us, we're like,
amazing.
But bahut tough hai yaar ye. Kya tough category hai, because isme Edgewell has tried, Chic has tried, India's best brand builder Darshan Bhai has tried. Supermax was like a 700 crore ka brand that doesn't exist today. So there is no competition. We are the only second competitor.
What, but Gillette is what percent market share?
Yaar, 80% plus.
He's given that.
Weird. Oh.
So it's like,
know,
company from Boston coming here.
And Arjun built it out. Arjun has played a big role in building it out.
I mean, even we have this brand called Perfora, which is an oral care, where these founders are turning it on its head. And it's this similar market structure where, of course, there are more. There's Pepsodent, there's also Sensodyne. Okay. But there's one large guy. And tier 2, 3 mein jao to mangtai, they don't say toothpaste, they say Colgate. De do. It is that strong.
But you know what? That may not, I don't know about oral care, but that becomes a strength. And I was talking to someone in the food space only. That becomes a strength and then very quickly transforms into a weakness.
Yep.
And the classic example is Bisleri. That Bisleri became anonymous, synonymous to mineral water.
Yeah.
But today, if you want Bisleri mango, and banda aquafi na de de, to aap leke chale aao. It's not like you're wedded to Bisleri.
Yeah. Xerox, all these brands.
Yeah, they don't care. They don't care. So, but for all the jatin, solid. But how do you guys like see consumer happening going forward? Do you think like a lot of the trends, like you said, right? But 75 saal mein jo kiya, hum 10 saal mein kar lenge, right? Mere ko lag raha hai ki hum 7-8 saal mein we have kind of become 250 crore ka dhanda ban gaya hai.
We're like, awesome, man.
We're 15% the size of Gillette today in India.
And I'm fairly certain, and educate me, that pretty much everyone would have said ki yaar, you can't take on Gillette, right?
Yeah.
Sunke mujhe bahut khushi hoti hai when people do it after that. Bada sukoon milta hai.
I can see my son in a couple of years using this.
Yeah.
I mean, like,
totally
cool for him to use this. You know, like, I get that.
Yeah.
It's, you know, he lives in Bombay. It's called Bombay Shaving Company. It's not Mumbai Shaving Company. So, you know, there's that, and people are embracing Indian brands.
Yeah, yeah.
It is when I was in college, I studied in the US. It was embarrassing to have an Indian passport. Today, you front it. I mean, everybody say, oh, you know, the Indian kids in the US, right, they're like, oh, you're from India, like you're Indian or you're American? I said, no, I'm Indian. I'm fresh off the boat Indian. You know, and it was like, today, you take pride. We arrived, you know. So it is a lot of pride in what we're doing right now. So I think that thing is also changing a lot.
We have now sell this in, for example, CSD has become a big.
Yeah.
And you should see, I'm sure for all your brand also, CSD will become big because the army and affiliated folks who are buying in CSD genuinely have a far higher indexation on
made in India.
Buy from India.
Yeah. Now they've mandated and they've removed all imported products altogether from CSD. Over a period, sub phase out.
Consumer bhi wahi mang raha hai. Consumer bhi wahi chahiye. Brand chahiye.
Yeah.
And global brand.
And achhe ban bhi to rahe yaar. Like this quality product coming out of India, why would I not? Like, there is no reason. It's at a better price point. It looks sexier. Yeah. By sure. So when you're talking about having something good looking in your magga and on the basin, this looks way better. Yeah. Like,
and the consumer, today's consumer is willing to experiment and he knows his stuff, right? I mean, you can write whatever you want on the pack. That'll get you one time.
Yeah.
But if the shave is not good, he's never coming back to you, right? Or even you eat, we can say best ice cream, ye kaju jada, all that. But they are an expert. Like once I told somebody, you don't understand. So that guy said, hold on. I am my taste buds expert. Yeah. You can't tell me what I don't understand or understand, right? So the same goes here. Right? You know how my skin feels after that is on me. So correct. I'm just saying that experience has to be there. And if it is there, then...
But overall, to answer your question around how we see consumer and so on, I'm always in sale mode. But I think today for us, right, it's a once in a 100-year opportunity. And I'm not sort of trying to hype this up too much. But if you look at it from the confluence of so many things coming together right now, which is improving incomes and, the proclivity to spend it, awareness that he's talking about, which is thanks to social and exposure.
Internet and so on.
Indian consumers in tier two are exposed to the same information as anyone sitting on the West Coast, right? Because information is flowing everywhere. Ability to spend. And then e-com, last 10 saal ki mehnat jo hui hai, which is investment into infrastructure to do the last mile and so on. And now we're seeing quick-com and so on. That is literally exploding the market. And COVID also had a role to play in that. So aap wo sab cheezein dekhein. And then the emergence of founders like you, availability of capital and so on. It's just everything coming together so well. And India, and I say this, it's probably there for the next 10 to 15 years because of the demographic dividend we have. 20 saal baad, Sauce will be investing in very different kind of brands, which will be looking at people who are willing to spend for life extension, health, wrinkle removal. Ye sab cheez aayengi. But ye jo 15 saal ki opportunity hai na, matlab, if we don't take a risk today, and if we don't invest in this shit, 30 years later, Sahil and Rishabh or, Ranveer and Shiva are going to ask us, ki tum saale kar kya rahe the when India was having its moment? Right? Because ye to nahi aane wala dobara. All these things lining up so well is not going to emerge again. And if we don't take the risk today and make great businesses out of India on the consumption side, domestic consumption, hum tech mein jo karenge, export karenge, manufacturing karenge, consume to karte hi rahenge saale, because it's this is, it literally gives me goosebumps every time I talk about it, because ye opportunity to yaar hamare liye served on a platter, agar humne nahi liya na to hum apne saath puchte agle will be jawabdar ki saale to humne kuch banaya nahi. So it's literally like that, we have to do this shit. Yeah. It's on us to do this.
Obligatory. Honest.
Yeah, it's not an option.
Movie karne motivation.
Yeah, but I also feel, for example, I think the learning for me has been fundamentally that India will buy a great product if the pricing is right, even if the pricing is a little premium. So yes. Red Bull, for example, is a classic example of beautiful, the premiumization of a single SKU business almost, right? तो कभी-कभी हम ये भूल जाते हैं. For example, when we see like the data that tells us कि ब्रिटानिया का 40% business comes from Good Day का 10 रुपए का pack, which is true.
Yeah.
Colgate का large chunk like more than
70. Let me flip this around. Do you know Apple sold in rupee value terms the same in iPhones that Hindustan Unilever sold? Do you know that? 1,00,000 crore का sale है Apple का. वो $1,200 का phone है, वो मैं नहीं afford कर सकता हूँ. और उतना 1,00,000 crore का एप्पल का सेल है हिंदुस्तान यूनिलीवर, विच इज लाइफ बॉय प्लस फेयर एंड लवली एंड ऑल ऑफ दोज नेम्स कंबाइंड एंड पॉन्ड्स एंड लक्स उतना है. सो लेट्स नॉट टॉक अबाउट, आई एम गोइंग टू दिस, देर आर सेगमेंट्स, देर आर सेगमेंट्स गोइंग एट डिफरेंट पेसेस. कैन यू बिल्ड समथिंग दैट दे वॉन्ट एंड पीपल क्रेव, लाइक हमारे मतलब गरीब देश में भी जब एप्पल का नया लॉन्च होता है ना 15 ईयर्स अगो, बिकॉज इट्स समथिंग पीपल क्रेव. Look at the sale of Mercedes. We've seen enough of that, yeah.
But do you think it's, do you think there is a, like I was thinking about this, I was walking. Have you been to the PKC mein Geo One?
Yeah.
Jahan pe wo Bay Club or
Bay Club.
Bay Club, I remember. So Bay Club aur uske upar jo mall hai. Kya dukaane hain wahan pe?
Nahi to naya wala dekha hai.
Haan, naya wala.
Nahi, the Bay Club wala alag hai. And this Geo
One cent, that huge ass screen, there's Tumi, Diesel, those ones. No,
No. उसका बाप खुला है अभी. Where they have Cartier, Rimowa, all these brands there.
Yeah, so
Geo, which is the Geo World Drive, and one is Geo Plaza, whatever.
I've not seen the newer one.
They've got the names wrong.
Yeah, again,
Indian accent, all of NMACC. Yeah. Like that.
Again, this is a very investor and economist fallacy of looking at India only as from the per capita income lens. There is disposable income is coming not just from your income, it's coming from wealth. And who's accounting for wealth? India has 50-50 crore ke tumhare Gurgaon mein apartments bik rahe hain, yaar. Like, what are we talking about? It's, there is wealth which is leading to consumption as well.
Is it concentrated in a small number of consumers?
It's huge. It is spread all over the country. It was spread and brands didn't have access to it till now. Because the only way to get to them was to set up retail. Ab main Jabalpur mein Mercedes ka showroom nahi, matlab, aur Mokobara ka store nahi lagaunga. But doesn't mean ki Jabalpur mein nahi baitha hai boss consumer. Is there a way to reach them? Is there a way to service them? Hum log ke liye e-commerce hai, now all those distributed pockets of wealth have got aggregated and it's become... And that number, by the way, that segment is the segment which the larger guys and the brands that you were talking about are not going to focus, because you see, the boardroom conversations there are about 10 bip market share.
Yeah.
For Colgate has a huge growth still to convert people from Daton and Koila to Dantmanjan, right? So they, of course, they're best equipped to win that battle.
Yeah.
For them, this is a really small play right now. But 10-15 saal mein, can I create a 1,000 crore business just catering to this part? 100%, yeah. 100% you'll create multiple brands. Oh, yeh toh hua hai China mein, yaar, yeh har, hum us inflection point mein hai. Aur humare paas, we have many more tools today to capture that. So, abhi, beauty and personal care mein dekho yaar, Shantanu, 5 saal pehle, 2018 mein, if you go down, who knew niacinamide, hyaluronic acid? Abhi, every girl, every girl talks about 5% niacinamide, 20% niacinamide mein differentiation.
Correct.
Right? So, that level of awareness has gone up exponentially. Yaar, hum log ke time mein, bathroom windows pe kya hota tha yaar, one shampoo, one soap, bloody that's it, that's the end of it, or and talcum powder. Up to there are like
hundreds,
yeah,
of
hair fall, anti dandruff, blah 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 blah. So that is happening. You know, Sensodyne came, it just took one plank. Sensitive nerves, 600 crore ka brand ban gaya sirf Sensodyne nerves. To ye segments to bani rahe yaar,
so premium,
yeah,
so
bahut mehenga toothpaste hai, bahut mehenga toothpaste hai. So segments ban rahe, people are paying, people want stuff, they will pay. It's not a, you know, absolute market ki bhai.
You're right. Also, averages screw up. Like, averages screw up.
And you have to see defensibility data and ability to create something. Na? Matlab, I cannot go and sort of take on Lifebuoy. If I want to go, I will not be able to take on Lifebuoy. Why should I? Like, there are enough white spaces out there for me. Matlab, Mama Earth ko dekho, yaar, leke chale gaya. End of the day, you've created a 200 million... dollar ka brand out of the blue, yaar. Yeah. And if you, and you know, you think about it from Unilever or any of the big boys' lens, you aggregate the revenue of startups in the BPC space. But if we're talking about a $1.5-2 billion number,
yeah,
being created in the premium segment,
yeah,
wo ban gaya hai, boss, wo market hai, wo 25-30% pe grow kar raha hai. So, aap 5 saal mein 10 billion ka apne market opportunity miss kar diya, bro.
That's true. Yeah. That is true. Do you think that, and that this is the question that I think you like for you also, I think last 2-3 years, there is like after 21 funding kind of thoda sa irrational boom also, but there's been like a significant cut down. Even for us, for example, we delayed our Series D for like till we hit a certain scale, and value discovery is still a lot more muted. But aapko aisa lagta hai ki yaar, profitability ke jo chakkar mein a lot of angel investments, for example, kind of did not play out. Let me frame this question sharply. Do you think early stage focus on profitability kind of cuts a brand at its legs?
100%.
Like when you were saying, we'll get profitable next year. So it inculcates good habits also. But do you think investment in brand...
No, he's not a startup. He's not a startup, by the way.
4 months purana
hai. But it's not... Yaar, tumne day zero, we've set up a plant for scale. We've building this company at scale. So in its DNA and its culture, it's a startup. But from a financial metric standpoint, you can't consider this to be...
We put in serious capital.
There was serious capital up front, right? Yeah. So therefore, for him, it's... He has to hit profitability.
This is from pressure from the big.
And he will hit, na, because he'll hit that scale.
Correct.
Any which way. But for younger companies, I agree. Yeah. I mean, to force a company which is on the path of just building its funnel and understanding from consumers ki bhai kaun sa wo product hai jo winner hai, abhi usne wohi nahi discover kiya hai, fir usko tum force kar do ki, you know, now you come down into a path of sort of profitability, that has, you have shortchanged its ambition.
I think there's also like a fine line, right? What happened in 2021 was the other extreme.
Yeah.
So people were buying sales. You know, they were not sustainable. Like what Manu said, right? Getting CM2 positive is the most critical thing. I think if I were to look at an investment also in a startup, I would say that not profitability is not important, but a legit road to profitability is important. And if that is clear, you know, then I think that's the right matrix.
But when you talk about market, for instance, you know, investors also swing on extremes. Yeah. I have always, right? And founders have to be a bit more long-sighted. And, you know, to think about the eventual outcomes of the business and how they want to build it, right? So, wo friction hamesha hi rahega. We've seen that pendulum swing the absolute other risk-averse way in 22, right? We've seen it thaw out a little bit in 23. I think 24 is going to be way better.
But हमारे कंपनी में आदतें अच्छी लग गई
वो बहुत अच्छी चीज हो जाती है
आदतें अच्छी
द लग्जरी ऑफ एक्सेसेस नीड्स टू बी ट्रिम्ड एज सून एज पॉसिबल
बट इट्स गुड फॉर
ग्रेट बिजनेसेस गेट बिल्ट इन फेयरली लिटिल कैपिटल
सो हमको वही है मतलब वी वेंट फ्रॉम लाइक अ सीएम टू 5% टू नाउ अ सीएम टू 21%
ब्रिलियंट है
हां तो लाइक सही है अभी नाउ वी आर इन्वेस्टिंग इन ब्रांड वी आर इन्वेस्टिंग इन distribution we are but you know EBITDA has kind of improved so like cool was it difficult yes did it force us to do things that a world of excess would not have forced us yes so that creates muscle for us for the
See, that's you know you didn't ask me this question but I'll say it anyway the number one reason why we got Manu on board right other than the fact that we have great relation and I mean mutual respect and you know I've thoroughly enjoyed working with him over the last 5 years as an investor and now obviously was, you know, to bring in the discipline. The biggest, you know, it's a great place to be where you have access to your own capital to invest in your new brand. But that can be your biggest curse also. Yeah. You know, when you start throwing money at problems, when you're not, you know, so you're not, you know, you're like, okay, I can solve for this by kharcha itna hi hai na, I'll hire two more people, I'll do this, I'll do that. And I think that's where...
I have to be the worst.
Yeah, and I tell my... Japesh, my CEO, my CFO, and that I am answerable to somebody who's external.
Yeah,
he's also a part owner of the business.
Yeah,
I cannot just be like, "Ha, dekh lenge." So that I think that discipline also for us was very, very important, and that's why because people ask me, "Why did you get an external investor from day one?" And I think for me that was the number one reason that.
Wow, I would have assumed that as a promoter. It would be a lot more kind of frugal with capital because it's your own, as opposed to kind of being a little more, you know.
Yes, but spendy. Look,
and I am very frugal. Push you ki nahi, Ankit, karna padega invest. You know, we'll let's
spend big and
full time. I'm not that guy. We're anyway. On the same page when it comes to that. And also, you're frugal with your own capital, but at the same time, it's also your own effort. And you know what I'm trying to say is that that you keep. If you don't have the money, that thought, like, I'll give an example, right? When I was running an older company, we never bought a new machine till 2012. Not because I wanted to save money. Wo paise the hi nahi. Every machine in our factory was second-hand. Europe ka machine chahiye tha, 20 saal purana, so we should get the best engineers to fix it and use it. Now, when we put up a new plant, my guys, we had this discussion. They said, oh, we'll get this, we'll get that. I said, at the end of the day, we have got zero sales. So, what I told them, we'll start small. You know, and obviously the idea is to think big. And once we've started small, we've thought big, then we'll execute quickly after that. And now we're at that execution phase. Because with no revenue to put in a, whatever, like a 100 crore rupee plant and all, it takes a lot of courage. So we balanced it out there. And I want that we get the best, we get the Rolls Royce of everything, equipment and all that. But I think now we're still not there. So I'm just saying that, discipline is very, very important. And trust me, you know, when you have it, you're not as frugal.
I agree. The classic example is a toothpaste. You buy a new tube of toothpaste for the first month, dhanandan laga rahe ho, press kar do. Jab wo khatam hone hota hai, then you start, and then you realize, yaar, itne mein to chal jata hai. Like, you can have a great brushing experience with like 1/10 of what you were using.
Yeah.
But it's the same thing with capital. When you raise it,
Yeah.
It goes out very quickly. And then...
And again, I said, your fiduciary responsibility is way more when it is somebody else. What even he said, when he's investing on behalf of his investors. So same thing here. Now when you have somebody else, you can't say, haan, thoda calculation mein mistake ho gaya. Ek bar bol sakte ho. Do bar bol sakte ho. Har bar to nahi bol sakte. So...
And how do you see Hocco kind of... It's like only 4 or 5 months old, but you've been running a business for so many years. You sold one.
So I joke with people, but I actually mean it, that... I want to do everything I didn't do with my older company. I never raised capital in my older company. I just sold it off.
You want to do things that...
No, so what I've never done before, right? So, never raised capital. Always thought... When I joined a moving train. Yeah. Everything was very easy. You know, now you're building the tracks and the train and then pushing it and then running it, right? So, very clear I want to raise capital. So, but I'm very clear that today, where I sit today, I want to list this business whenever I can. You know, if I mean, that's my dream. I mean, it's not even a strategy or a.
Did you have that dream with Havmor?
No.
नहीं बेचते तो IPO कर लेते
थी वो hindsight की मैं बात करता ही नहीं हूँ
because तो बढ़िया IPO market बनेगा
वो as I said like you know in hindsight everything is 2020 you know I could have run it to the ground during COVID I could have made it 10x of what it is today who knows
correct
but that was not meant to be my journey or whatever it is I have nothing but respect for the brand but now I have nothing to do with it right so I can't say anything but what I want to do right now is that with this brand I want to take it public people tell me oh running up listed companies 10x harder and all that. I said, I'm okay with that. You know, I mean, there are thousands of listed companies. We'll be one of them. And what fun, yeah. You're to live quarter to quarter. I said, even better, you know. So I mean, again, it's easier said than done. Hopefully someday we'll get there. So that's the vision with Hocco, that scale it up quickly and just make sure that we continue doing what we're doing. And, you know, they always say once the business becomes boring, that's when you really unlock value. So I thought this business become boring maybe 5-7 years later, but the way things are going, that we already cracked the product, makes you crack the branding and all of that. So I think we'll
fly in the head.
This now it's all about scaling up and how quickly we can do that. So hopefully before next summer we'll be ready for that.
What are the publicly listed ice cream companies in India now?
Only Wadilal.
Dincha kedare?
No. Oh, it's from Nagpur. Great guy, Mr. Rana, but they're not listed.
And Natural is also privately.
No, private. There is no other listed company in India.
I mean, Unilever has a segment.
No, that way there is Hudson Agro, there is Unilever, but they are not listed. They are like it's dairy company an and FMCG business. Company that has not it's even nice 5
pure harder. Play, there's only Wadilal.
Yeah.
Our stock has done really well, by the way.
Yeah.
As is the industry.
Yeah. So, no, as long as you didn't make any mistakes in the last 2-3 years since COVID, the whole industry has grown. And you ask people why, nobody knows the answer. People have just started consuming more ice creams. It's got to do with infrastructure, power.
Yeah, you were saying that.
We
don't lose. That's like cold.
Cold chain
supply is like very difficult. Yeah. Now
it's improved. Those building blocks are there. Quick commerce apna dal raha hai, cold storage. The intermediaries now like Frogo and so on are doing the middle layer. So it's.
You say it right. Like our generation, like our cohort, jo hai, 2015-16-17, those brands Amazon, Flipkart ki wajah se bane the. आज के रेट में मेरे को लगता है स्पेशली इन फूड स्विगी इंस्टामार्ट ब्लिंकिट पे ही बनेंगे ब्रांड्स
देयर विल बी अ बिग ड्राइविंग फोर्स आई थिंक एंड सर्टेनली लेवल्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एज अ प्लेइंग फील्ड एंड टू मी अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आस्क मी डू आई सी दीज गाइस कम्पीट विद अमेज़न आई हैव अ डिफरेंट व्यू आई थिंक दे एक्चुअली कम्पीट विद किरानास मच मोर एंड इन फैक्ट देयर मॉडल इफ यू लुक एट इट इज फार similar to Kirana's in that limited SKUs, but fast moving, right?
They compete with Amazon because I think ultimately what you're right. So from a behavior standpoint, they compete with
because idhar koi discovery ke liye nahi ja raha hai Blinkit pe. Discovery aapki long tail is sitting on Amazon. They don't buy the inventory, so it's still yahan pe these guys actually buy your inventory, and therefore they're very like a Kirana ka store. Itna hi jagah hai, boss.
2000 SKU per store. So they are basically measuring revenue per cubic meter per unit type. Broadly, वही है उनके लिए.
So right? किराने की दुकान में भी if you take all your SKUs from Bombay Shaving, he'll be कि अच्छा
10 चीज़ भैया 5
हाँ भैया ये 5 दे दो हमें लगता है ये चलेंगे फिर देखेंगे.
Correct.
And that's exactly how these guys operate. And you know.
So that was even our learning. You know, we said, oh look, we've got this for quick. They said your packaging is too bulky. I said no, but look at our premium it looks. He said no, but it's our space requirement.
Don't see it.
We're actually changing our. The boxes and all to make it slightly smaller so that it fits in there. And they look at it as, see, for them, it's ice cream is one category where they have 20-30 brands. So you better stand out.
Yeah,
I think that's what will be our biggest challenge.
Yeah. For us, I think what we are seeing, for example, there are some days now where Blinkit sells more than Amazon, man.
Yeah.
So what we're seeing is consumer, agar purchase intent cultivate kar liya aapne, to banda pehle Blinkit pe dhoondega.
Wohi ho raha hai.
Fir Amazon pe dhoondega.
Wohi ho raha hai. And it's and especially in food, yaar. Like aap Epigamia ko dekho, biggest channel ban gaya uske liye. And I think Shashank ke liye bhi it's a very big channel. To sabhi ke liye, Perfora ke liye bhi it's becoming. Hamara ek brand hai called My Muse, which is into sexual intimacy products. Wahan pe log
अभी चाहिए ना, अभी चाहिए. We sell for direct, we do entire D2C for directs.
For directs, right?
For directs. So like अभी चाहिए और discreetly चाहिए. Direct में वो भी है कि सीधा brand से आ रहा है, मतलब it's an authentic product. Yeah. So you don't, like, because the cost of failure of a condom is huge.
So you don't want to buy it from a reseller platform. Yeah.
But वही है, I think even for, I think वो Albi like puts out really cool stats. उसका था like, I think tomatoes, milk, condoms, and to the volume of
milk is the number one, right? On quick commerce.
Milk, that's what they were to, like some days. I don't know whether it's over a period of time, but some days I remember milk, then tomatoes.
It's just made people so lazy, you know. It's just like
we had someone on this show. He's the founder of Joy Cosmetics. He said that ye sab convenience ke chakkar mein hum agle generation ke saath pata nahi kya kar rahe hain. So like, you know, honestly, you could have said that about the calculator or the aeroplane or any innovation. Was are we spoiling the next generation?
But we'll have more shit to stress about for sure.
Why was he see younger people?
That's like why we have ice cream. It's a stress-free zone.
But I think, you know, as we enter the twilight of this conversation, I think it's been fascinating for me to hear about Sauce and the investment you've made. Manu, I think huge respect. I wish like we would have known each other.
I wish the same, yaar. But thank you so much. We're just starting. We're still very, very young.
And I would love to work with you in some shape or form.
Oh, let's do that anyway.
If you're raising a fund and if you have...
We're always raising. We are raising our third fund now.
Okay. So I would love to talk to you about whether I could kind of be a part of that. But amazing to see the kind of founders you support, the way they talk about you, by the way. Even Prachi, for example, the moment I told her Manu's coming on the show, so like, say hi to him from my side. I love him. Yeah, absolutely. Like, you know, like, people like you, even the way, like, the way he is, like, he's such a successful promoter and so on, but the way promoters talk about investors gives a huge amount of, and today after spending so much time, we always meet in parties, etc. Yeah. You never really get to unpeel the person or get to know them in any meaningful way, but isme, like, I now get why people speak about you in the superlative, and thank you for the work you do, and, you know, genuinely, I think, I hope there are more people, you know, maybe people at Sauce who kind of mentor and they become bigger and bigger.
Yeah, I mean, I'm actually, the thing I'm most proud about is my team and, you know, what they're doing with founders, for founders. All of that is like, it's a really small knit team, six of us. We love spending time with each other. It's been fun. The entire journey has been fun. Everything else, the outcome is obviously great, but it's been a good journey. I've been enjoying it very much. And I hope I can continue to do this. I hope I keep getting the faith of founders and, you know, they'll let me sort of be part of their journey. Honestly, Sauce is the sum total of the efforts of our founders. That's it. Usse zyada kuch nahi hai. Humne kya kiya hai? We play a very small role in what is really their vision, their journey. And usme humme bhag mil jata hai, toh we're really happy. Like, we're so proud of Sangeet and Shashank and Yogesh and all of these guys. It's just really fulfilling.
Even Super Tales are IIM Lucknow, by the way. So my seniors are IIM Lucknow.
Really?
Vineet was 2 years my senior in undergrad also.
I know, man. I think I'll start MBA again.
IIM Lucknow.
No, I said to get some talent from there or some new ideas or something.
But Ankit, also thank you so much for, you know, like, for being so generous with your time and your ice cream. But also, more than anything else, I think to see someone who is, you know, honestly, like, I always, like, I come from a service background, and then, like, my parents are serving services, then entrepreneurship, and the kind of conversation I would have with my dad later on, or about for his company, his funding, etc. I saw him build a tech company, go through the 2008 crisis, etc. I'm assuming when, as a child, you would have kind of gone into, you would have seen your father on a scooter selling ice cream and so on. To see that culminate into a mega successful sale, to then again take some time for yourself and then come back with such a bang is amazing. And, you know, like, I think people like you are inspiration for all of us, you know, in terms of, and I would love to be involved in your journey in whatever way possible. I have learning, of course, but, you know, I would love to come and see your factory. And
Really, thank you for having me. And so much to learn from you also. And the way you've gone about things. But I think this is the longest Manu and me and sat together also. So I've also learned so much from, and I keep learning. And I would say one thing, you know, with Manu was, like, you know, many people can give money, many people can give gyan, but I think what Manu and Sauce bring to the table is they actually, you know, feel, make you feel that they are part of your success. Like, he's not BSing whatever he's saying, because I've experienced it, you know. And the one thing, like, Manu knows about this, that I actually reached out to a few founders that he's invested with. And not one person, even the ones who have failed in their business. And they still had, like, you know, people have been successful, let's say, is very good and all. But even the ones that, of course, when you do 20 investments, few fail. I reached out to those guys. And they all said that Manu helped us through that phase and, you know, selling out or divesting or whatever it was. So, amazing. I think, yeah, so that's, for me, that is
tough times, tough times. Character of our investor, for sure.
When you're doing well, everybody will be by you, right? So, I think hats off there. And again, as I said, with you, I would love for you to come see our factory.
Yeah,
come,
for sure.
Give us some, I mean, I love the innovation that you're doing, yeah. And super cool. I mean, and as I said, like, I think a category which I thought, like, can be so boring, you made it so cool, so interesting, so a lot to learn.
Yeah.
And I've been thinking we'll do some cool collab or some flavored foam.
We'll have a charcoal foam. Charcoal and lychee flavor.
We'll do something. Hopefully in the future, we'll do some cool collab or something like that.
No, we should. I think... Yeah.
Edible shaving cream. Yeah.
Like, put it here and eat some other. Oh, God. But yeah. No, I think across categories, across tenures, like, this area of the office is an area where we give to founders who we invest in, either Barbershop or me, or if someone in the leadership team is invested, they can work from here for play until they're 2, 3, 4 employees. And unko kya hai? Matlab, they get access to our content studio, they can procurement karni hai, jaake char logon se puch lo, Facebook marketing karni hai, char logon se puch lo. So they get access to that, plus the coffee machine, AC rooms, etc. And we get to see how today's founders are thinking about their business. And there's so much to learn. So, you know, I would love to kind of come to next time. I'm in Ahmedabad 100%. For a sales visit or something. I'll hit you up. Before we go, I think any parting thoughts for that one person who's watching? I think, you know, there are people. Hamara consumer dekh lo, 20-21 saal ka bachcha hai, who's watching this show. College mein, doston ke saath hostel room mein baithke, he's thinking ki yaar naukri leni hai ya fir, you know, jaake bahar jaake kuch apna karna hai. वो पेपर में पढ़ रहा है funding freeze, you know, winter है, ये है, वो है, startup unicorn हो गया, etc. I met a brand manager in alcohol. He said our core TG now is young professionals who are drinking our alcohol and discussing their startup idea.
Oh.
That's their core TG. They started a podcast on entrepreneurship with an alcohol brand.
Amazing.
They started an entrepreneurship podcast to get to their consumers, because so this is what they're doing. So any final parting thoughts to anyone watching who may have not taken the plunge or who's kind of building up the courage or whatever. Anything from you guys? You go first.
Yeah, for me, I think investors, which I represent at the community, we're in the business of being wrong. We fail more often than we succeed. We get 80% or even more of our decisions wrong, right? That's the... So when you're building your business, do not look at us on how to build your business. The answer lies with your consumer. And as the old adage goes, consumer knows it best. Tumhare ko sare jawab wahan milenge. Not from... And the validation is not in the unicorn tag or not in being able to raise a round or any of that. I'm telling you from the investor's perspective, we're absolutely clueless about your business. It is, I don't know the ice cream business yet. I don't know the shaving business at all. I will back you because you understand your consumer and the opportunity hopefully much better. So do not therefore worry about what the investor, the investment community is saying or telling you how to run your business. Hamare sare businesses, honestly, which have done well, have been ones that have been rejected every day. I mean, you talk to any investor who's at peace with himself, he'll tell you his anti-portfolio is so good.
Right?
So,
what's your anti-portfolio?
बहुत है यार अब मैं
बता चाहती
नहीं नहीं बहुत लंबी list है. But the point is, if there's one takeaway, the answer is not sitting with, certainly not sitting with investors. And if it is one person that you need to talk to, it's your consumer. So that's
that's a big point. Yeah, absolutely, completely agree. And it's not as, it sounds obvious, but it's not as obvious. Because a lot of times founders, and me included, I'm guilty of having built a quarter or two of business to meet metrics that were discussed in a boardroom.
Yeah.
As opposed to meet expectations that a consumer would have had in a bathroom.
Yeah.
And for us, bathroom is bigger than boardroom always, right? So, very fair point. Ankit, what about you?
See, itna to gyan nahi hai mere paas, but I'll just say, you know, look, so 2-3 learnings that I have, right? I think before you start anything of your own, especially you're young, you're hungry, you know, get some real world experience. I mean, that's what helped me, you know. I went to college, I went to the US, all that. But, you know, I worked in this, and my entire company makes fun of me because every meeting of mine starts with some example. I worked in this fast food chain called Panera Bread in the US for 1 year. But till today, my learnings from there are like more than those 4 years of college and whatever I've learned there. So getting some real world experience in a similar field, I think, is paramount. It prepares you for whatever it, you know, and start as if you're a person with means and all that, please don't say I worked in my uncle's company or something. Go get a job. You know, I think I would highly recommend doing that. That's probably more important than an MBA also. And the second thing I would say is that we all should try and build business for perpetuity and businesses for, you know, to outlive us, rather than figuring out, you know, again, this whole last few years have all been about exits. We start a business saying, oh, I'm going to do this and I'm going to exit at this value and all of that. I just feel that money should be the byproduct. It's easier to say when you have money, but money should be the byproduct.
Yeah.
You know, solve for a need, solve for a this thing. And the one other thing that I strongly feel about is don't try to be so different that to explain to a consumer becomes very hard. Because even I've spoken to a lot of investors and all, they ask me, what is your moat? What is your this? I said, why? My moat is me. You know, my moat is the team. My moat is it is a combination of everything. I cannot, you know, like, I am not going to be able to create a brand like Maggie that is my moat or whatever it is. Like, you know, wo nahi hoega. So just, you know, once you do a lot of things right, that becomes your moat. So I'm just saying that it's very hard for you to solve for these intellectual conversations. Just keep doing what you want to do and just make sure you do it right.
Yeah. Another thing, I think it stayed with me. He said, brand is about mental availability and physical availability. Important. Mm-hmm. But more importantly, ye dono aap over a period of time crack kar loge, but over a period of time, find out who loves you, right? And work for why they're loving you. And then make sure that the number of people who are loving you are increasing more and more.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. I think broadly, if you're in the ballpark of economics, etc., and you have a good team executing, and you're able to figure this out, you'll solve for it. But if you're not close to the consumer, and executing on why they're loving you and more of them are loving you, then it becomes very tricky. Then everything else is actually kind of a distraction. So this has been amazing. I have so much to kind of talk more about. And I think this should be episode one of a series of with the both of you. We could actually do one in their factory in Hocco factory, maybe.
We will, whatever. This is our first.
Yeah.
We lost our podcast virginity. Yeah. Couldn't have
was
been
I kind
better.
Enough? Yeah.
You were very gentle.
You got some aloe vera and everything.
The first one is always special.
It's my privilege and pleasure entirely.
No, it was so much fun, man. I'm so glad we did this.
Thank you. And thank you for bringing Ankit. He told me that, you know, let's not wait for Arjun.
I needed to have something substantial in the show. So it's
only
not
a very
me.
Substantial point.
No, but the ice cream was just like legit. It was beautiful.
So by the way, you know, at the airport, they were not letting me check in the ice cream. That's the first. I said, listen, and I told them, I am first I said, boss, tum jante nahi ho main kaun. I have checked in ice cream for all my life. Yeah, right? You know, so you cannot stop
the Ahmedabad airport.
Yeah. So then they're like, no, but I said, listen, I'm telling you, again, I was like 75 years, say, my family's been in the ice cream business. We were a Gujarat brand till 2008, right? So my dad, every time we should go to Bombay, it should be fixed. In fact, we had a Thermocol ka dabba with a handle, proper this, that and all. So it was a given that ice cream always get checked in. Yes, they had this.
But what are the issue now? Too many of them.
No. So they're saying, no, dry ice is not allowed. I said, of course, they'll puncture it. I said, puncture it. All those. But they said,
gas buildup can happen, which can lead to a...
But this, but that. I said, trust me.
Shantanu ke BarberShop pe
So then they said, we'll send on the next flight. Because by that time, check-in had closed. I said, no, worse. You need to get it on this flight. Otherwise, I'll have to take the next flight with the ice cream. Or let me hand carry it or something. But long story short, it made it on the flight. So
today morning, is it?
Yeah. Like, I took an early morning flight. So, yeah.
Wow, thank you so much.
I would have come last evening, but then again... Abhi distribution nahi hai Delhi mein, so ice cream, then how would I got it last night? And
So, but anyways.
But this has been a pleasure. Yeah, and thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we have hampers for you as well. Hey, do we have some new stuff in that, by the way?
Yeah.
Because the last hamper was a little old.
With Karan kind of thing. Huh?
Yes. So this is for you because
Wow.
This you will enjoy the multi groomer. Yeah, there's a foam. There's
super.
A razor.
My favorite shampoo. Damn cool.
Very sexy, man. The packaging is like insane.
By the way, if you want, this is not flight friendly.
So that's fine. I have check-in luggage. Yes.
Perfect.
I'll take it out.
Perfect. But thank you so much.
So kind of you, man. Thank you. Really
thank you for coming. Thank you, Ankit. Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much.